Live from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, it's time for Arkansas Tech Golden Suns basketball. Tonight, Arkansas Tech hosts the Henderson State Reddies in great American Conference action here on the EAB Sports Network. Good evening, everybody. My name is Sam Streisner. Thank you for joining us. Kelly Davis will be along in just a few minutes. The Golden Suns are 12-12 overall and 9-11 in the GAC. An Arkansas Tech win or a Wichita Baptist loss tonight would allow the Golden Suns to clinch their 18th consecutive postseason appearance. Henderson State is 17-9 overall and 13-7 in the GAC. The Reddies have won two consecutive games and four of their last five. They are locked into the number four seed for the GAC tournament, regardless of what happens tonight or in their regular season finale on Saturday. We will take a 30-second break and then return with more on the Lexicon pregame show. Lexicon can help you reach your goals and success. Go to lexicon-inc.com/football to learn more. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, this is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Test 1, 2, 3 for the truck. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Honor them right now.
Welcome back into the Lexicon pregame show from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, where Maissa Marsall and Dana Thompson, the Golden Suns' two seniors, have just been recognized during a pregame ceremony here by head coach Dave Wilbers and the rest of their teammates as the Golden Suns get set for their final home game of the year. And it comes against Henderson State. The Golden Suns lead the all-time series 75-22. Right now, we will pause 2 minutes for the national anthem. This is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Welcome back into the Lexicon pregame show from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville as we get set for this 98th all-time women's basketball meeting between Arkansas Tech and Henderson State. Golden Suns lead the all-time series 75-22, including a 39-9 record against Henderson State in women's basketball games here in Russellville. Earlier this season, Henderson State defeated the Golden Suns 84-80 on December the 9th at the Duke Wells Center in Arkadelphia, and three-point field goal shooting was a big difference in that game as Henderson State was 11 of 29 from three-point range, while Arkansas Tech was 5 of 18. The 11 three-pointers by the Reddies back in December are the most three-pointers allowed by Arkansas Tech in a game this season, and this has been a tough matchup for the Golden Suns as of late. Henderson State has won the last 6 meetings in this series and 9 of the last 12. Arkansas Tech's last win over Henderson State was a 98-62 victory here at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville a little over 3 years ago on February 4th of 2021. With a win tonight, the Golden Suns clinch a berth in the Great American Conference Tournament, which will begin on Thursday, March the 7th at Fire Lake Arena in Shawnee, Oklahoma. Henderson State is already locked into the number 4 seed for the GAC tournament, and so the Golden Suns clearly the team with a little more to play for here tonight. But as we have seen from this Henderson State team in recent years under head coach Jill Thomas, they always come ready to play. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we will step aside for 1 minute and then come back with more on the Lexicon pregame show, including the starting lineups. This is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back with you on the Lexicon pregame show. Lexicon can help you reach your goals and success. Go to lexicon-inc.com/football to learn more. As we get set for Arkansas Tech and Henderson State, it is a Great American Conference doubleheader here tonight at Tucker Coliseum, as coming up at approximately 7:45 p.m., it'll be the Wonder Boys of Arkansas Tech taking on the Henderson State men. We are going to be about, a little more than 15 minutes late in getting this doubleheader underway, and that is because the Henderson State bus encountered some travel difficulties on the way up from Arkadelphia earlier this afternoon. But we'll get underway just a little after 5:45 and bring you both games here tonight on the EAB Sports Network. Taking a look at the starting lineups for tonight's game. First, for our guests from Arkadelphia, the Henderson State Reddies, 17-9 overall, 13-7 in the Great American Conference, coached by Jill Thomas in her 11th season with a record of 164-134. Starting at the guards, Tori Gittens, a 5'11 graduate student from Sherman, Texas, 11.5 points and 2.8 rebounds per game. Ashley Farrar, a 5'11 graduate student from Green Forest, 15.3 points, 4.4 rebounds, and 1.8 assists. Brinley Huggins, a 5'10 sophomore from Pangburn, 7.6 points, 2.2 rebounds. And Olivia Allen, a 5'5 sophomore from Batesville, 7.9 points and 2.1 rebounds. The forward for Henderson State is Bobby Basil, a 6-foot junior from The Woodlands, Texas, 3.4 points and 5.8 rebounds per game. Now the starters for the homestanding Arkansas Tech Golden Suns, their final home game of the year. The Arkansas Tech women are 12-12 overall and 9-11 in the GAC, coached by Dave Wilbers in his 17th season at Arkansas Tech with a record of 354-133. Brad Palmer is the assistant coach. The student assistants are Bailey Smith and Nancy Kaufman. Starting at the guards, Maissa Marsal, 5'10 senior from Brazil, 9.9 points, 5.1 rebounds, 4.5 assists, and 2.7 steals per game, along with Clara Grace Prater, a 5'10 junior from Valonia, 7.1 points, 3.4 rebounds, 1.3 assists, and Alex Hill, 5'10 junior, Harrison, 12 points, 3.1 rebounds, 2.5 assists, and 1.6 steals. The forwards are Dana Thompson, 6-foot senior, Miami, Florida, 10.3 points, 9.4 rebounds, and one blocked shot per game, and Julie Wagner, 6'2 junior, Humboldt, Tennessee, 7.4 points, 5.2 rebounds, and 1.1 blocked shots per game. And as we bring Kelly Davis into the conversation, Kelly, when you talk about Henderson State, it all starts with three-point shooting. The Reddies lead the conference in both three-point field goal percentage and three-point field goals made. They're top 20 in the country in both of those categories. And so defending the three-point arc, perhaps the most important key tonight for the Golden Suns.
Well, I think that and guarding number 10. She's a grad. It's her grad season, and Ashley Farrar is, you know, from Green Forest. She knows how to play basketball, knows how to shoot the ball, and so she is one of the keys to this game tonight. Is that, you know, she is the floor leader out there when she's on the court. So you got to be careful of her for sure, and you kind of limit the damage, and not let her get on a hot streak for sure. But then you got all the others to worry about as well. So pick and choose what you want to do, but. You know, like he said, we've got to guard that three-point line and don't let it happen. You know, losing by four with as wonderful of a game, that shooting game that they had in that one, we can do it. All we got to do is just play some good defense.
Ashley Farrar is the all-time leading scorer in Henderson State women's basketball history with 1,775 career points. But by her lofty standards, she has been struggling a little bit as of late, averaging just 8.9 points per game over her last seven. And in the month of February, Farrar is just 7 of 32 from three-point range. That's 22%. The player who's had the hot hand as of late for the Reddies has been Tori Gittens, the 5'11 graduate student from Sherman, Texas. Gittens had 14 points at Southeastern Oklahoma State on Saturday a week ago against East Central. She had 21 points, and over her last four games, Tori Gittins is 10 out of 15, 67% from three-point range. And you don't have to tell the Golden Suns about Tori Gittins. She had 21 points, including 5 out of 7 from three-point range in the first meeting between these two teams down in Arkadelphia. This is the Lexicon pregame show. Lexicon can help you reach your goals and success. Go to lexicon-inc.com/football to learn more from the Alathus Realty broadcast position. We will step aside for 1 minute and then come back and get you ready for tip-off. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network. This has been the Lexicon pregame show as we welcome you back into the Alathus Realty broadcast position. And Kelly, this is one of six Great American Conference doubleheaders being played across Arkansas and Oklahoma tonight. And we are definitely down to crunch time in the race for conference championships and for berths and seeds in the Great American Conference tournament.
Yeah, we sure are, because it's not been decided. There's five teams that has already punched their ticket, including this Henderson State team. And that's Southern Nazarene, Harding, Northwest Oklahoma, and Southwest Oklahoma, as well as Henderson State. Like you said, Henderson State has already locked up the number four seed. But with two games left, you know, whoever wins the conference, you could have co-champs, Harding and Southern Nazarene. Harding has, you know, kind of stumped their toe last couple of games and dropped, so they're two games behind Southern Nazarene. But they can still, if they win tonight, and tomorrow night, Southern Nazarene has a hiccup. Anything can happen. So like I said, Arkansas Tech, Baptist, Washington, still fighting for the last three spots. So tonight, Southern Nazarene is at Northwest Oklahoma. UA Monticello is at Harding. Central is at Southwest Oklahoma. Southern Arkansas is at Washington.
Back to the Alathus Realty broadcast position for the opening tip in 1 minute. This is Golden Suns Basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Welcome back to John E. Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. The Golden Suns will wear the dark uniforms tonight at home, trimmed in green and gold. It is a blackout night at Tucker Coliseum, and so both Arkansas Tech teams will wear their dark road uniforms. Henderson State wearing its white uniforms, trimmed in cardinal and gray. And it is time for basketball at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. Glad to have you with us on the EAB Sports Network. The opening tip is in the air, and it is controlled by Arkansas Tech. And Alex Hill will bring it into the front court. The Golden Suns averaging 68.7 points per game. That's fifth in the conference. Arkansas Tech third in the league in field goal percentage at 41.6%. Feet on the right baseline for Clara Grace Prater. Prater shoots from 10 feet and scores. Clara Grace Prater, who's been in double figures and scoring eight of her last 13 games, knocks down the mid-range jumper to give Arkansas Tech the first 2 points of the game. Left-handed dribble drive for Henderson by Brinley Huggins. She throws it out right wing and throws it away. Out of bounds intended for Olivia Allen. And the turnover for Henderson State gives it right back to Arkansas Tech. This Henderson State team is missing a big piece since the last time we saw them. They lost Natalie Cardenas, a 5'8 freshman guard from Mesquite, Texas, who was averaging almost 12 points per game for the Reddies. She's been unavailable since January the 13th. Right side, Maissa Marsal with it for the Suns. Feeds Wagner going to the basket. Layup up and good for Julie Wagner. And 51 seconds into the ball game, Arkansas Tech leads it 4-0 on 4 points from inside the painted area. Right side, Tori Gittens dribbles left, leaves it out front with Huggins. Huggins dribbles right to the elbow, bounce pass to Allen. Allen dribbles into the paint, throws it out to Farrar. Farrar hard driving to the basket, off the glass, too high, no good. Defensive rebound, Maissa Marsal, and Marsal got hit in the face by Ashley Farrar. It is Farrar's first. It is team foul number one against Henderson State, and the basketball belongs to the Golden Suns. Maissa Marsal has now appeared in enough games this year to qualify among the Great American Conference leaders. Maissa is third in the conference in assists, third in assist to turnover ratio, and she's tied for second in steals. And she had quite a road trip to Oklahoma. On Saturday, in the loss to Northwestern Oklahoma State, Marsal had 12 points, 3 rebounds, 6 assists, and a career-high 7 steals. Bounce pass into the post here is deflected and stolen by Bobby Basil, and Brinley Huggins will bring it up for the Reddies. Huggins stops at the top of the key, goes left, picked up there by Marsal. Pass to the top for Gittens. Gittens defended by Prater, dribbles left. Marsal takes her now, feet into the post, batted away by Wagner. Golden Suns playing a 2-3 zone. Allen shoots for three and scores. Olivia Allen with the three-pointer from the right wing. She is a 40% three-point shooter for her career. Henderson State this year as a team shooting 35% from beyond the arc. Best in the Great American Conference, 20th in the nation. Alex Hill drives to the basket and lays it in. Alex Hill has the answer for the Golden Suns. And as we go under 8 minutes to play in the first quarter, the score is Arkansas Tech 6, Henderson State 3, but not for long, as Brinley Huggins, a 33% career shooter from three-point range, takes the handoff and knocks down the tray, and she ties the score at 6 apiece.
Yep, there's that three-point shooting that you mentioned before the game.
Ball out of bounds on the baseline, last touched by Arkansas Tech, and it'll yield the first substitution of the day as Olivia Allen is out for the Reddies, replaced by Jada Pickens, a 5'6 senior guard from Conway. Pickens averaging 7.4 points and 3.1 rebounds per game. Ashley Farrar throws it up right side for Huggins. Her three-pointer is off to the right. Rebound out of bounds, last touched by Arkansas Tech. Possession stays with Henderson State with 20 on the shot clock, 7:32 left in the first quarter, and the score tied at 6. Henderson State 2 out of 4 from the field so far. Arkansas Tech 3 out of 3, but the Golden Suns have committed 2 turnovers. Tori Gittens with it on the right wing. Gittens throws it across to Ashley Farrar. Farrar had 33 points, a season high against Arkansas Tech back in December. Drive to the basket, no good for Huggins. Defensive rebound, Dana Thompson. Thompson came into the night third in the GAC in rebounding this year at 9.4 rebounds per game. Thompson fights for position in the low post, and they're going to call her for a foul, saying she pushed off on Bobby Basil. The foul on Dana Thompson is her first, team foul number one against Arkansas Tech. Huggins is out for Henderson State, replaced by J.J. Edens, a 5'9 senior guard from Luther, Oklahoma. Edens averaging 5.8 points, 4.1 rebounds, and 1.5 assists per game. Edens right-handed dribble drive across the lane, defended by Marsal, throws it out for Pickens. Pickens dribbles right, running jumper, no good. Defensive rebound by Maissa Marsal of Arkansas Tech. Marsall looks to push it on the fast break. Crossover dribble, trying to get by Pickens. Feeds it on the baseline for Wagner. Her 18-footer is no good. Defensive rebound by Ashley Farrar of Henderson State. 6:39 left in the first. Tied at 6. Eddins for 3. No good from the right corner. And on the rebound, a whistle and a foul against Henderson State. And that is going to be the second personal foul on Ashley Farrar. And that'll get Farrar out of the game. She'll be replaced by Olivia Allen. And two early fouls for Ashley Farrar means the Henderson State will have to play without its leading scorer, not only this season, but all time for at least a little while.
Well, she probably won't sit out too long.
Into the front court, Maissa Marsall behind the back dribble, draws three defenders, throws it out to Frater. Three-pointer is short. Rebound, Henderson State. Jada Pickens with the carom. Pickens has had a bit of a strange year. She started off very slow offensively. Then she had a stretch from late January through mid-February where she averaged 17.4 points per game. She has cooled off since then. Marsall makes the steal for Arkansas Tech. And after Marsall scooped up the loose ball, a whistle. Let's see what we've got. The official is going to say a held ball.
Well, he easily could have called the foul, but he didn't.
A held ball is the call. The possession arrow favors the Reddies, and they will throw it in from the far sideline. And a new face in the game will trigger it in. That is Sam Basson, a 5'7 freshman guard from Allen, Texas. Basson averages 3.9 points and 1.3 rebounds per game. Olivia Allen hands it off to Basson. She dribbles right, guarded by Clara Grace Prater. Suns have gone back to a man-to-man defense, and there's a steal by Maissa Marsall. Marsall dribbles into the front court. Score still tied at 6. 5:45 to go in the first quarter. Prater throws it out front for Marsall. Marsall surveys the defense. Golden Suns have missed their last two field goal tries. After starting 3-for-3, Prater drives. Out of control scoop shot, trying to draw the foul, but no whistle. Defensive rebound, Henderson State. Now Allen in transition, leaves it out front with Pickens. Pickens dribbles right, gives on the wing for Basson, across to Allen, fakes the three, drives, bounce pass intended for Basil, was kicked out of bounds by Julie Wagner, and Henderson State will throw it in from the baseline with 20 on the shot clock, 5:19 to go in the first quarter, and the score still tied at 6, as neither team now has scored in more than 2.5 minutes. Inbound pass comes out front for Basil. She leaves it on the left wing with Allen. Now a handoff for Basson. Eddins with the basketball, drives and dishes back out front for Sam Basson. Basson had 2 points in their 75-66 win at Southeastern Oklahoma State on Saturday. One on the shot clock. Eddins, 16-footer, no good. And Dana Thompson has the defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech. We mentioned Dana is averaging 9.4 rebounds per game. She is trying to become just the fifth Golden Sun to ever average 9 or more rebounds per game for an entire season. Feed down low for Julie Wagner. She loses it out of bounds on the baseline, and that'll take us to a timeout on the floor. 4 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first quarter. Arkansas Tech 6 and Henderson State 6 from the Alathus Realty broadcast position. We step aside for 1 minute. This is Golden Suns basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Changes for the Golden Suns in for the first time are Haley Wyrick, a 5'8 sophomore guard from Piercy, 8.6 points, 2.2 rebounds, and Shelly Butler, a 6-foot junior from Nassau, Bahamas. Butler, 3.3 points, 3.5 rebounds. Henderson State into the front court, 4:29 to go in the first quarter, score tied at 6. Olivia Allen dribbles to the right elbow, throws it out on the wing for Sam Basson. She leaves it at the top of the key with Edens. Edens dribble drive down the right side of the lane. No good. Offensive rebound, Bobby Basil. Basil, under pressure from Marsall, loses it out on the near sideline. And the Reddies will maintain possession, but with just six on the shot clock. In for the Reddies is McKenna Winans, a 6'1" senior forward from Parkersburg, West Virginia. Winans averaging 3 points and 5.9 rebounds per game. Three on the shot clock. Right corner three is good for Olivia Allen. Allen is 2 out of 2 from beyond the arc. 4:07 to go in the first quarter, and Henderson State has its first lead of the night at 9-6. Maissa Marsall guarded out front by Brinley Huggins, passes left side to Prater. Clara Grace leaves it back at the top of the key for Marsall. Shot clock at 18, pass on the wing for Wyrick, and Wyrick stepped on the far sideline. Turnover number 4 for Arkansas Tech. The Golden Suns average 18.3 turnovers per game, which is most in the GAC this season. Henderson State, though, does not force a lot of turnovers. They are 11th in the league in turnovers forced, as Reddy opponents only averaging 14.4 turnovers per game this season. Right-handed dribble drive by Tori Gittens, defended by Clara Grace Prater. She gives to Huggins. Huggins drives the left side of the lane. Layup try, no good. Rebound out of bounds off Arkansas Tech, and Henderson State will maintain possession. The Reddies have now missed 7 out of their last 8 field goal tries. But they still lead 9-6 because the Golden Suns have turned it over 3 times in the last 4.5 minutes. Inbound pass. Brinley Huggins gets it in the left corner for Olivia Allen. Allen tries to back Marsall down. Maissa is called for a foul. They call Marsall for the blocking foul. It is Maissa's first.
Oh, this one official is really calling things close.
It is
very close.
Team foul number 2 against the Golden Suns. And Brinley Huggins will make the inbound pass for the Reddies as they work to get the shot clock set to 20.
Hope that doesn't come back to hurt us.
Inbound pass to McKenna Winans. Winans had 2 points and 9 rebounds against Southeastern on Saturday. They give to Edens. Edens drives, cut off by Wyrick. Turnaround jumper up, and J.J. Edens gets the bounce. Edens with her first 2 points of the game after she had missed her first 3 field goal tries. And Henderson State has now scored the last 8 points in this game to grab an 11-6 lead. Marsall into the corner for Wyrick. Catch and shoot. 3 is good. Haley Wyrick with the 3-pointer from the left corner. For Wyrick, it is her team-leading 33rd 3-pointer of the year. The Golden Suns are back within 2. Huggins misses a 3 for the Reddies. Defensive rebound, Haley Wyrick of Arkansas Tech. Suns push it. Wyrick stops on the right wing, gives out front for Marsall. 3 on the way, off to the left. Offensive rebound, Julie Wagner. And it is going to be a pushing foul on Wagner to get that rebound. The foul on Julie Wagner is her first. It is team foul number 3. And the basketball belongs to the Reddies as a result of that foul on the Golden Suns. And Olivia Allen will bring it up for the Reddies. 2 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first quarter. Henderson State 11, Arkansas Tech 9. Drive and an offensive foul. Offensive foul on the Reddies. And that'll give the ball right back to the Golden Suns with 2:35 left in the period. The offensive foul on Olivia Allen is her first personal foul. Team foul number 3, and Maissa Marsall will bring it up for the Suns. A week ago, Maissa almost had a triple-double. She had 9 points, a career-high 10 rebounds, and a career-high 11 assists at Southwestern Oklahoma State. Alex Hill throws it out left wing for Clara Grace Prater. Prater drives the baseline and draws a foul on Brinley Huggins. Huggins first, the team's fourth, and Arkansas Tech will throw it in from the baseline as Jada Pickens returns for Henderson State, and Brinley Huggins will check out. Pickens, way back when as a freshman, had a 21-point game here at Tucker Coliseum back on January 9th of 2021, and that was her career high until earlier this year when she had 27 against Ouachita Baptist. Pass deflected by J.J. Edens, stolen by Jada Pickens. Left-handed layup on the fast break, blocked by Prater. Rebound saved in. Reddies maintain possession. In the corner, it's Pickens. Throws it out to Edens. On to Olivia Allen. Allen lost the handle. Marsall dives for the loose ball. Let's see what we've got. Should be a held ball and should be possession arrow to Arkansas Tech, and that'll be the case with 1 minute and 55 seconds to go in the first quarter. And Henderson State leading this one 11-9. Marsall into the front court. Picked up out front by Tori Gittens. Passes right wing to Alex Hill. Hill drives the baseline, loses it out for Arkansas Tech's fifth turnover. And the basketball belongs to the Reddies. Golden Suns had 23 turnovers in their 67-64 loss at Northwestern Oklahoma State on Saturday. It was Arkansas Tech's most turnovers in a game since January the 20th. Left elbow jumper is good for Olivia Allen. Allen is 3 out of 3 from the field. She has 8 points, and Henderson State leads 13-9. Marsall stops the right elbow, feeds it down low, intended for Dana Thompson, but poked away out of bounds by J.J. Eddins. And the Golden Suns will throw it in from the baseline. Arkansas Tech 3-2 in its last 5 games, trying to finish strong and get into the GAC tournament. They can clinch their spot with a win tonight as that 15-footer from the right baseline rattles out no good for Clara Grace Prater, and Henderson State goes the other way with the defensive rebound. Right side to Allen. Dribble drive cut off by Hill and Marsall. Pass out to Pickens. Pickens leaves it at the top of the key with Gittins. Gittins dribbles right. Step back jumper for a long 2 is no good. And the defensive rebound goes right to Maissa Marsall. Golden Suns out rebounding them 8-7. Pass ahead for Shelly Butler on the left block. She dribbles through the lane, puts it up, no good. Defensive rebound by McKenna Winans of Henderson State. Into the front court come the Reddies. Gittins drives, layup try blocked by Butler, rebounded by Winans, putback try blocked by Butler, and rebounded by Shelly Butler, who has been a much improved player here over the last week. Butler had 2 points and 5 rebounds at Northwestern on Saturday. A week ago against Southwestern, she had 8 points and 4 rebounds. Butler 5 out of 7 from the field over her last 2 games, and now making an impact here tonight on the defensive end. 19 seconds left in the first quarter. Henderson State leads 13-9. Alex Hill guarded by Jada Pickens. Passes on the left side for Marsall. Shot clock at 3. Three-pointer is too strong, and the shot clock goes off. The game clock is still running. They're going to have to deal with that at some point as they stop the game clock now with 3.1 seconds left. We'll see if anybody noticed that the game clock kept running. I think Jill Thomas noticed, the Henderson State head coach.
Yeah.
Should have been somewhere in the range of, I don't know, 7 or 8
about
seconds.
7.7.
And so they will indeed
somewhere in there.
They will indeed go to the monitor to check and see how much time should be left in this first quarter. Henderson State leads it here 13-9. And while we have a break in the action, we check with Kelly Davis for an update from the Great American Conference Women's Basketball Scoreboard.
It is Harding 36, UA Monticello 26. One game we're going to watch closely, Southern Arkansas 37. Ouachita Baptist 34. It is Southeast Oklahoma 34, Oklahoma Baptist 31, East Central 25, Southwest Oklahoma 18, and Southern Nazarene is trailing Northwest Oklahoma. We knew that would be a good game tonight. They trail by 6. It's 26-20, 1:41 to go in the first half of that game.
Did you notice that our sign guy has recruited a helper?
I tell you what, he's doubled up tonight.
Doubling down for the home finale.
Finale for senior night.
It is not the finale of the season, though. We'll be with you on Saturday afternoon from the W.T. Watson Athletic Center in Magnolia as the Golden Suns and Wonder Boys will wrap up the regular season with a doubleheader at Southern Arkansas. Radio-only coverage the rest of the way after tonight. We'll be with you on KCJC 102.3 FM. And for those of you outside the listening area, you'll want to download that EAB Media Group app. And you can listen to the Golden Suns and Wonder Boys on your phone wherever you go. They put 7 seconds on the clock. Henderson State into the front court. Allen's layup try blocked by Shelly Butler. And that's how the first quarter comes to an end. Henderson State 13, Arkansas Tech 9. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Golden Suns basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back at Tucker Coliseum for the second quarter and in for the first time tonight, it is Jackie Rollins, a 5'10" sophomore guard for Arkansas Tech out of Mustang, Oklahoma. 3.4 points and 1.4 rebounds per game. Jackie Rollins, Dana Thompson, Clara Grace Prater, Shelley Butler, and Alex Hill are the five for the Golden Suns as we begin the second quarter. Henderson State leading 13-9. Gittins misses a three. Offensive rebound off the hand of Shelley Butler right to Olivia Allen of Henderson State. And now a traveling violation called on Jada Pickens with 9:45 left in the second quarter. And it'll be Jackie Rollins to bring it up for Arkansas Tech following the Henderson State turnover. The Reddies give the basketball away for the fifth time. The two sides are now even in that regard. Alex Hill dribbles left to the top of the key. Passes on the wing for Clara Grace Prater. Prater dribbles right. Thompson sets a screen. Pass on the baseline for Butler. Butler dribbles out of trouble. Gives right wing for Prater. Bounce pass for Dana Thompson. And Thompson is fouled by Jada Pickens. Pickens' first personal foul is the first team foul against Henderson State here in the second quarter. And Jackie Rollins will throw it in for the Golden Suns. Checking in for Henderson State is Sam Basson, replacing Jada Pickens. Jackie Rollins gets it into Clara Grace Prater. Prater, she used her dribble, so she needs some help. Throws it out to Alex Hill. Hill goes left. Butler sets a pick. Hill drives. Left-handed layup up and good for Alex Hill. Hill has 4 points. Alex has been shooting the ball very well as of late, 54% from the field over her last three games. She had 13 points at Northwestern Oklahoma State on Saturday, and she cuts the Reddies' lead here to 13-11 with 9:03 to go until halftime. Olivia Allen with it in the lane, loses the ball. It's stolen by Shelley Butler of Arkansas Tech, and the clock has malfunctioned. It does this during pregame almost every night. I've never seen it happen during the game, but it has done the same malfunction that it does during pregame every night, and so Daniel Gallegos, our director of athletic communications, is well-schooled in how to deal with this, and I think they may be going to a backup unit here as I see Troy Norton, our clock keeper, unplugging some things, and so this may take just a moment, and while they work on that, we will check with Kelly for not only a GAC women's basketball scoreboard update, but also an update from the 5A state tournament as our Russellville Cyclones are in action.
Yeah, they are. Right now, it's in the second quarter. It's 24-22, the Cyclones over Lake Hamilton. There were some other high school games going on today, but we'll have some halftime scores for you. Harding 39, UA Monticello, and that is at halftime. Also at the half, Southern Arkansas 42, Ouachita 36. In halftime, Southeast Oklahoma 36, Oklahoma Baptist 32. Also at half, East Central 25, Southwest Oklahoma 20. And at the halftime, it is Northwest Oklahoma 26, Southern Nazarene 22. All of them are at halftime because we got a late start here due to some bus trouble with the Henderson ladies. So we got pushed back about 15 minutes. And that's why we're already seeing halftime scores.
Elsewhere in Arkansas Tech athletics, the Golden Sun softball team will be playing some neutral site games this weekend as the turf project over at the Chartwells Women's Sports Complex is ongoing. And so the Golden Sun's home series this weekend against Henderson State has been moved to City of Colleges Park in Conway. Golden Suns 9-4 overall this softball season and 1-2 in the GAC. Meanwhile, the Wonder Boys baseball team is on the road to Arkadelphia this weekend. The Wonder Boys 8-8 overall, 3-3 in the conference, winners of 5 in a row. And they will look for their first road win of the year when they take on Henderson State at 6 p.m. Friday at Clyde Berry Field in Arkadelphia. Follow live coverage of Golden Sun softball and Wonder Boys baseball all spring at ArkansasTechSports.com. The clock issue has been resolved thanks to some quick work by Daniel Gallegos, and we are ready to continue with 8 minutes and 50 seconds to play in the second quarter, and Henderson State leading 13-11. Daniel looking pensively up at the clock, but it does wind back into motion. And now a whistle, and the official says the shot clock didn't start, and so we will try again. If at first you don't succeed, what do you do, Kelly?
Try again.
That's what they say. Alex Hill will throw it in from the near sideline for Arkansas Tech. Alex Hill, Maissa Marsall, Shelley Butler, Jackie Rollins, and Dana Thompson are the five for Arkansas Tech. Dana and Maissa, the two seniors that were honored before this game got underway for the Golden Suns on the occasion of Arkansas Tech's final home game. No senior day later for the Arkansas Tech men. The Wonder Boys have no seniors on their active roster, which
that's
is
a good thing.
That's a very good thing, especially when you're in the running for a conference championship. An illegal screen set by Shelley Butler. Butler's first personal foul. Team foul number one this quarter. And the basketball belongs to Henderson State. Sam Basson will bring it up. Basson, Eddins, Gittins, Basil, and Pickens are the five for the Reddies. Ashley Farrar is on the bench with two fouls and has been for quite some time. Pass into the post was stolen away by the Golden Suns. Shelley Butler with the loose ball. Her outlet pass is deflected out on the far sideline by J.J. Eddins. And the Golden Suns will go the other way, courtesy of the turnover by Henderson State. It is the seventh turnover of the evening for the Reddies. Arkansas Tech is plus one on the turnover margin. But the Reddies have a 7-4 edge in points off turnovers. Henderson State leading 13-11. 8:15 to go in the second quarter. Maissa Marsall floats in the lane and misses the 10-footer. Offensive rebound, Shelley Butler, but she stepped on the baseline, and the basketball will belong to Henderson State. It'll be Sam Basson to bring it up for the Reddies. Basson did not score but had three assists when these two teams got together on December the 9th down in Arkadelphia. Right-handed dribble drive by Pickens, spins, tries a fadeaway jumper, and draws a foul against Arkansas Tech as the official says that Alex Hill got her across the arm. The foul on Hill is her first, team foul number two, and Jada Pickens to the free throw line where she is a career 74% shooter. Pickens appearing in her 74th game for Henderson State, came into the night with 537 career points, 247 career rebounds, and 105 career assists. Pickens so far this year for Henderson State is an 85% free throw shooter, 41 out of 48. The first free throw try is woefully short, and Pickens will have another try. Pickens only played 2 minutes in that December meeting between the Golden Suns and the Reddies. Makes the second free throw, 7:57 to go second period, and Henderson State leads 14-11. Maissa Marsall over half court, picked up by Brinley Huggins. Gets a pick from Dana Thompson, goes right. Turnaround jumper up and no good from 10 feet. Rebound loose on the baseline, out of bounds off Bobby Basil. And Arkansas Tech will maintain possession with 20 on the shot clock. 7:45 left until halftime. Maissa Marsall to make the inbound pass. And a whistle and an illegal screen set by Arkansas Tech. They say that Dana Thompson was the guilty party. And that will be the second personal foul on Dana. With 7:44 to go until halftime, Coach Wilbers finding out that's her second foul. Pickens bounce pass ahead, layup up and good for Bobby Basil. Basil with her first bucket of the night, 7:32 to go in the second quarter. And Henderson State has opened up a 16-11 lead, despite the fact the Reddies are just 6 out of 20 from the field. Golden Suns are 5 out of 14. Drive by Alex Hill, misses the runner. Put back try by Dana Thompson is no good, and Thompson drew a foul. She will shoot two free throws. The call on Henderson State is on Bobby Basil for a hack across the arm. Basil's first is team foul number two. Shelley Butler is out for the Golden Suns, replaced by Julie Wagner. And Dana Thompson to the free throw line where she is a career 56% shooter. First try for the Miami, Florida product is good. Dana appearing in her 48th game as a Golden Sun tonight, made her 41st start in the green and gold, came in with 408 career points and 400 career rebounds.
That was the only third field goal attempt all game so far for both teams.
Thompson, fourth. Thompson misses the second one, goes 1 out of 2. And with 7 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the second quarter, Henderson State leads 16-12. There's a steal deep in the far corner by Maissa Marsall. 3-on-2 break, gives to Rollins. Jackie drives and draws the foul. Jada Pickens arguing it should be a held ball. Now maybe a conversation between two officials. They are going to award two free throws to Jackie Rollins. The pushing foul on Henderson State is the second personal on Jada Pickens, team foul number three. And Jackie Rollins will step to the line for Arkansas Tech. Jackie, a career 63% free throw shooter. First one is on its way and good for the Mustang, Oklahoma product. Jackie Rollins so far this year is shooting 76% from the line. She had 2 points in the loss at Northwestern on Saturday. Offensive rebound off the missed free throw by Dana Thompson and a bonus possession for the Golden Suns, down by three with just under 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. And the official blew his whistle, I believe because of a shot clock issue. They've got that resolved. And Alex Hill will throw it in from the far sideline. Gets it into Maissa Marsall. McKenna Winans checked in for Henderson State during that last dead ball, replacing Bobby Basil. Feed into the post for Dana Thompson. Turnaround jumper, no good, but a foul on Winans. McKenna Winans picks up her first personal foul. Team foul number 4 on the Reddies.
Might could shoot free throws early in this quarter.
Dana Thompson right back to the line where she went 1 out of 2 a few moments ago. Thompson with 1 point and 4 rebounds so far tonight. Dana had 10 points, 8 rebounds, and 3 assists at Northwestern Oklahoma State on Saturday. A week ago against Southwestern Oklahoma State, Dana had 14 points, 12 rebounds, 4 assists, and 2 steals. Thompson with 9 career double-doubles, 8 of those have come this season. Second free throw try is good. Dana gets both of those, 6:46 to go until halftime. And the Henderson State lead is 16-15. 3 on the way, no good for Huggins. Defensive rebound, Maissa Marsall. And a chance for the Golden Suns to take their first lead in a long time. Layup try by Julie Wagner wouldn't go. The rebound is off Huggins, out of bounds. And the Golden Suns will keep it with 20 on the timer.
Yeah, they went up and competed for the shot there and just made her miss.
It would be Arkansas Tech's first lead since the Golden Suns were in front 6-3 at the 8:03 mark of the first quarter. Inbound for Alex Hill, stripped away by Basson, out of bounds. And Arkansas Tech will maintain possession with 19 to shoot. Tori Gittins, who is second in the nation in three-point field goal percentage this year at 51.9%, is back in for the Reddies. Gets it in. The Suns get it in, I should say, to Jackie Rollins. Rollins dribbles on the left wing, guarded by Brinley Huggins, throws it out front to Alex Hill, on to Marsall on the right wing. Maissa thought long and hard about a three, 7 to shoot. Marsall wants to drive on Gittins. Now she shoots over the help defender, J.J. Eddins, and scores. Maissa Marsall with her first 2 points of the game, and it gives Arkansas Tech a 17-16 lead, and now a traveling violation against J.J. Eddins.
Yeah, that little rabbit step.
Turnover number 9 for Henderson State. And the ball right back to the Golden Suns, who will have a chance to add to their 6-0 lead, or 6-0 run, I should say. Alex Hill, Maissa Marsall, Clara Grace Prater, Julie Wagner, and Dana Thompson are now the 5 after Prater checked back in a moment ago in place of Jackie Rollins. Pass to the right wing for Prater. Left-handed dribble drive to the free throw line. 15-footers, no good. Offensive rebound, Dana Thompson. Thompson works on Winans. Fadeaway jumper is no good. Rebound tipped by Wagner, out of bounds. And it'll belong to Henderson State with 5:49 to go in the second quarter and Arkansas Tech leading 17-16.
Well, neither team's just shooting lights out so far.
Into the front court, Olivia Allen hands it off left wing for Gittins. Gittins dribbles right, gives to Huggins. Now to Allen. Allen dribbles into the lane. Step through, left-handed layup, no good. Rebound, Julie Wagner of Arkansas Tech. Henderson State in this second quarter with that miss is now just 1 out of 4 from the field. Drive by Marsall. Fakes, goes up from the left block, no good. Offensive rebound, Wagner. Putback try is good. Julie Wagner with the offensive rebound and the putback. 4 points and 3 rebounds for Wagner. 5:15 to go in the half. And an 8-0 run has staked Arkansas Tech to a 19-16 lead as Clara Grace Prater blocks the Gittins shot. And it got a piece of the Reddies on the way out of bounds. And so the basketball will belong to the Golden Suns.
Went up and contested it. Made her miss that one.
Maissa Marsall across half court. They swing it left side for Prater. Clara Grace dribbles right. Shot clock at 21. Now Alex Hill with the ball. Gets to the free throw line. Gets downhill. The runner is up and no good. And a foul on Brinley Huggins. Huggins' second personal foul. That's team foul number 5. And the Golden Suns will be in the bonus for the final 4 minutes and 52 seconds of the second quarter. And there's timeout on the floor. 4:52 left in the half. Arkansas Tech 19, Henderson State 16. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Golden Suns basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back with you at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville as the clock has malfunctioned again, and Daniel Gallegos, our Director of Athletic Communications, is working furiously on it. Good to see you, Mr. Keel, Mr. William Keel. Local legend here, taking some photographs tonight. Always good to see Mr. Keel. Perhaps on the short list of the foremost photographers in the history of this community, and they are working now to get that clock issue resolved. And while they do that, we will turn to Kelly Davis for an update from the GAC women's basketball scoreboard.
Yes, sir. All the games have started in the second half now. It's Harding 41, UA Monticello 33, Southern Arkansas 42, Ouachita 36. It is Southeast Oklahoma 40, Oklahoma Baptist 36, East Central 30, Southwest Oklahoma 20. And not yet started yet. It's still 26-22, Northwest Oklahoma over Southern Nazarene. The getting ready to start the second half in Alva.
It looks like, at least for now, the clock situation has been resolved with 4 minutes and 52 seconds to go in the second quarter. And Arkansas Tech leading Henderson State 19-16. Golden Suns on an 8-0 run, and Alex Hill at the free throw line. Alex, a career 71% free throw shooter, first one on its way and short. Alex, appearing in her 75th game as a Golden Sun, came into the night with 722 career points, 295 career rebounds, and she's always been a money player at the end of the season. She's always done her best work. She misses both of those free throws, though, and Henderson State out of there with the defensive rebound. Into the front court, Sam Basson, and a whistle as the shot clock did not start, and it's turning into a rough night for what is widely recognized as the best table crew in the Great American Conference. It's no fault of their own, though. It's just a mechanical malfunction right now that they're working through over on the far sideline. These guys are so widely respected that they will be the table crew for the Great American Conference tournament in Shawnee, Oklahoma next week. Right side, Tori Gittins. Pass out front for J.J. Eddins. I think they're going to have to keep the shot clock over there now manually. Eddins throws it out front to the top of the key for Sam Basson. Basson dribbles right, gets downhill, shot clock at 7. Pass out front for Allen. Allen at the free throw line, defended by Marsall. Goes up the left hand, no good. Rebound out of bounds, last touch by Arkansas Tech. And Henderson State will maintain possession with 20 on the shot clock. 4:21 left in the second quarter. Arkansas Tech 19, Henderson State 16. Inbound pass deflected by Alex Hill. Loose ball at the top of the key. Marsall dives for it, but J.J. Eddins gets the loose ball for Henderson. Handoff on the right wing for Basson. Across to Eddins. Eddins drives, gets into the lane. 10-foot jumper is no good. Defensive rebound by Julie Wagner of Arkansas Tech. 4 minutes, 4 seconds to go until halftime. Arkansas Tech up by three. Maissa Marsall leaves it on the wing with Prater. Prater drives into the lane, kicks it back out to Marsall. Maissa for three, it is short. Offensive rebound, Julie Wagner back to Marsall. Maissa, no look pass out to Wagner. 15-footer, no good. Defensive rebound by McKenna Winans of Henderson State. It didn't lead to anything, but what a pass by Maissa Marsall.
That was pretty awesome.
Drive by Basson. Throws it out right side for Olivia Allen. Left-handed dribble drive into the lane. They're going to call Marsall for her second personal foul. And with 3:33 to go in the half, I bet we'll see Jackie Rollins up off the Arkansas Tech bench pretty soon. It sends Olivia Allen to the free throw line for the first time tonight.
The coach has made no move yet.
Allen is a career 90% free throw shooter. First try for Olivia Allen is up and good. Allen this year is 47 of 51 from the free throw line, 92%. She would obviously be among the national leaders if she had enough attempts to qualify, but she does not. She makes both free throws, 3:33 to go in the second quarter, and the Arkansas Tech lead is cut to 19-18. Bounce pass to the high post for Julie Wagner. She turns, pass into the paint is intercepted by Olivia Allen. Arkansas Tech with its ninth turnover. The two sides are now even in that regard. Basson gets into the lane on the offensive end for Henderson State. Throws it out to Olivia Allen. Allen drives the right side of the lane. Layup up, no good. Defensive rebound, Julie Wagner. Suns the other way. Henderson State now has missed six consecutive field goal tries. Marsall driving in, trying to draw the foul. No whistle. And Shelly Butler will check in for Arkansas Tech, replacing Dana Thompson. So it's Shelly Butler, Clara Grace Prater, Julie Wagner, Alex Hill, and Maissa Marsall, who is still in the game with two fouls. Inbound pass, lobbed for Butler. Butler's got some room, drives to the basket, lays it in, and draws the foul on Bobby Basil. Foul on Basil is her second, and it'll be a three-point play opportunity for Shelly Butler. And now Jackie Rollins will indeed replace Maissa Marsall among the Arkansas Tech five.
Because she knows how to play defense one way. That's very aggressive.
Yep, no, you cannot risk a third foul on Maissa, and she's not going to back down from anything. Shelly Butler makes the free throw, completing the three-point play. 2:58 to go in the second quarter, and Arkansas Tech leads 22-18. Sam Basson hands it off to Olivia Allen. Allen dribbles right, nearly carried the ball, but was able to keep her right hand just on top of it. Spin move by Eddins. She scores on the seven-footer from the middle of the lane. Eddins has 4 points and three rebounds. 2:38 to go in the half, and it's 22-20 Arkansas Tech. Into the front court comes Jackie Rollins. Rollins pulls up for three, short from the left wing. Defensive rebound for Henderson State by Sam Basson. Basson dribbles to the top of the key, hands it off to Tori Gittins. Gittins goes left, gives to Eddins. Eddins gets downhill, the runner off the window, no good. Defensive rebound, Julie Wagner of Arkansas Tech. Wagner's sixth rebound of the first half. Golden Suns are plus eight in the rebound category. And a foul committed by Henderson State. As Jackie Rollins drove to the hoop, she drew the foul on Olivia Allen.
That's her second.
And it'll be two free throws for Rollins as the Golden Suns are in the bonus.
With 10 points. They'll have to get her out.
Jada Pickens will check in momentarily for Henderson State. First free throw try for Jackie Rollins is good. She is now 2 out of 3 from the free throw line tonight. The Golden Suns as a team are 6 out of 10 from the line tonight. On the season, the Golden Suns shoot just under 69% from the free throw line, which ranks 10th among the 12 members of the Great American Conference. Rollins makes both free throws. 2 minutes and 8 seconds to go in the second quarter. Arkansas Tech 24, Henderson State 20. And Pickens does indeed replace Olivia Allen for the Reddies. So it's Sam Basson along with J.J. Eddins, Jada Pickens, Tori Gittins, and Erica Patton, the five for Henderson State. We'll get Patton properly introduced in a moment. Feed into the post for Patton, defended by Julie Wagner. Dribbles into the lane. The shot off the glass is no good. Defensive rebound by Alex Hill of Arkansas Tech. 1:47 left in the second. Out to Rollins. Jackie Rollins backpedals, gives top of the key for Alex Hill. Hill wants to drive on Eddins. Layup good and a foul. J.J. Eddins called for her first personal foul, and it'll be a three-point play opportunity for Arkansas Tech's Alex Hill, who will step to the line in search of her seventh point of this first half. Golden Suns shooting just 33% from the field, including 31% in the second quarter, but they've been able to build a six-point lead as Hill misses the free throw. And Henderson State goes the other way with the rebound. Golden Suns have done it with their defense, forcing Henderson State to miss eight of its last nine field goal tries as Pickens drives and draws a foul on Jackie Rollins. Foul on Rollins is her first, and it'll be two free throws for Jada Pickens. Promised you we would get Erica Patton properly introduced. She is a 5'9" junior forward from Denton, Texas. Patton averaging 1.4 points and 1.1 rebounds. Only played 1 minute on Saturday at Southeastern Oklahoma State. Pickens makes both free throws, a minute 30 to go in the half. And it's Arkansas Tech 26, Henderson State 22 from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. Final home game of the year for the Golden Suns. Arkansas Tech is 8-5 here at Tucker Coliseum this year. Drive by Alex Hill. Layup try no good, but an offensive rebound for Julie Wagner. Prater shoots from inside the top of the key and scores. 18-foot jumper for Clara Grace Prater. She's got 4 points, now 289 for her Arkansas Tech career. Pickens tries to answer. Can't get the runner to go from right at the front of the rim. Out to Basson for three. It is good. Sam Basson with the three-pointer from the right wing, and she slices the Arkansas Tech lead in half. It's 28-25 with under a minute to go in the first half. Left side, Jackie Rollins, defended by Tori Gittins. Pulls up, shovels it out to Alex Hill. 36 seconds left in the half. Alex Hill goes right, defended by Patton. Lobs it down low for Shelley Butler. Butler's shot is blocked, rebounded by Jada Pickens. And now the Reddies, if they want to, can hold for the final shot of the second quarter. Left side, Pickens, defended by Clara Grace Prater. Drive, lost it, got it back. Held ball between Wagner and Pickens, and the possession arrow favors Arkansas Tech, and now it's the Golden Suns who can hold for the final shot of the quarter, unless that call is going to be overruled. Thought for sure we had a held ball, and now some disagreement. And I think they're going to send both teams to their benches and go to the monitor here with 16.8 seconds left in the second quarter, and Arkansas Tech leading 28-25. And the play is under further review by our officiating crew. Reminder, coming up later tonight at approximately 7:45 p.m., the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys will play their final home game of the year. The Wonder Boys right in the thick of the Great American Conference championship race, just one game behind Southeastern Oklahoma State. Entering play tonight, the Savage Storm with its final road game of the year. Southeastern is at Oklahoma Baptist tonight, so that's a score we will be tracking closely as the evening unfolds, as the Wonder Boys hoping to go 2-0 during this final week of the regular season, tonight at home against Henderson State, and then Saturday afternoon at Southern Arkansas. Wonder Boys hoping for two wins and then some help in order to catch Southeastern Oklahoma State. The Wonder Boys one game back with two to play as the review from the monitor continues on the far side.
What are they reviewing by chance, maybe?
I have absolutely no idea, unless they thought there was a collision with a potential for a flagrant foul in the pileup to get that held ball. That's about all I can imagine. They have completed their review, and now the conversation begins out near midcourt as all three officials talk it over. With 16.8 seconds remaining in the second quarter, and Arkansas Tech leading 28-25, it appears
called a jump ball.
That the call of a held ball will stand. So nothing changes on the review. And now the Golden Suns have it with 16.8 seconds left in the half and leading 28-25. Jackie Rollins, Clara Grace Prater, Shelley Butler, Julie Wagner, and Alex Hill are the five who will try to get a bucket for the Golden Suns here right before halftime. Stay with us during the break. We will visit with Mark Downey, the head men's basketball coach at Arkansas Tech, if he can pull himself away from that Russellville Cyclones game, which he has a very strong interest in. Into the front court, Jackie Rollins. defended by Erica Patton. 5 seconds left in the quarter. Out to Prater. Clara Grace to the left elbow. 15-foot jumper, no good. Rebound, Henderson State. And that's how the half comes to an end. At Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, our score after two quarters of play is Arkansas Tech 28 and Henderson State 25. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we step aside for 2 minutes, and then we'll talk it over with Mark Downey. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back with you at halftime of tonight's women's game with Arkansas Tech leading Henderson State 28-25. We are joined now by Mark Downey, head coach of the Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys, who picked up their 20th win of the season Saturday afternoon, in Alva by defeating Northwestern Oklahoma State 70-63. And Coach Downey, as you've come off that win, it's that time of year where you're trying to peak and be at your absolute best. At least the best you can be with the available personnel going here into the last couple of games of the regular season. Where do you feel like you are on that process of trying to peak here at the right time?
I feel like we're pretty healthy. Sorry I'm distracted.
I understand completely.
Rice play and the Cyclones cut it to four.
Yep.
I feel like we are pretty healthy for the most part. The guys that are giving us minutes are healthy and ready to go. So, I feel really good about where we're at right now. You know, a lot of this year has been up and down, losing guys and not knowing who we're going to be able to play. And, getting these guys back and being at full strength, it's been pretty nice for us. So we'll take it. We'll just keep trying to win one game at a time and see what happens. You know, it's all we can do. It's all we can control. Southeastern's got two tough games this week, too. So if we just keep winning, eventually it'll fall in our favor.
You know, when you're trying to fire on all cylinders, you've really got to have every guy on this roster right now kind of performing close to optimum to do the things you want to do this week and next week and hopefully beyond that. When you crunch the numbers, Tommy Camerad's scoring in February is down a little bit compared to what it was in January. Now, sometimes you look at a number like that, sometimes it means something, sometimes it doesn't. And sometimes it's just a matter of the way they're defending you or just the matchups. Is there anything that you're kind of in Tommy's ear with offensively right now to try to kind of get those numbers maybe back up where they were in January?
He's been sick.
Yeah.
He was really sick on the road and just has been trying to get his strength back. So I have no doubts that Tommy's going to, you know, respond here and make some shots and get back in the scoring column. He might even have a big night tonight, so we will see. But Cash has stepped up and played better. Obviously, Taylen's there, and Cade's the same as Tommy. I don't think he had a big game a couple games ago, but he hadn't been shooting it as well. And I think that these guys are going to come along at the right time, and we're going to be all together. And like you said, firing on all cylinders late in the year.
Henderson State has lost some guys as the year has gone along. They're getting pretty thin. And here in recent games, they've just kind of given it to Zion Patterson and asked him to go get it. He had 20 at Southeastern. He had 38 a week ago at East Central. What have you got to try to take away from Zion Patterson?
We've just got to make him uncomfortable. We've got to be physical with him. He likes to have space. He's really good, elite at mid-range. So we've got to really pressure him, get up on him. We'll use some length and some quickness on him tonight. We talk about putting him in crowds is what we say, put him in crowds, get in the gaps, make him take tough shots. He can make tough shots, but if we limit them, I think we'll be pretty good. And then we've got to keep him out of transition and keep him from getting easy ones, and then keep him off the glass as well. They're really long, and they start, you know, besides our point guard at 6 foot, they start 6'4", 6'7", 6'5", and 6'10". So they're really long. We've got to keep them off that glass.
All right, go be Pops now for a few minutes and pull Bryce and the Cyclones through there.
I will. They're down 5, and hopefully they can get it close. They need a bucket. There's only 2 minutes left.
And no matter what happens, that's been a great season for those young men.
It has been, and they've got a lot of bad luck this year. And I'm super proud of those guys. And Coach Chenault's done a wonderful job.
He certainly has. Thank you, Mark.
Thanks, Sam.
That is Mark Downey, the head men's basketball coach at Arkansas Tech, as the Wonder Boys get set to take on Henderson State. In case you have no idea what we're talking about, his stepson Bryce Beavers plays for the Russellville Cyclones. He's the point guard for Russellville High School. And as we speak right now, Russellville High School is engaged in a very close first-round game at the 5A state tournament in Searcy. Here in Russellville, we are at halftime of the women's game, and the Arkansas Tech Golden Suns have a 28-25 lead over Henderson State. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we will step aside for 3 minutes and then come back with a look at the GAC scoreboard. This is Golden Suns basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back with you at halftime from the Alathus Realty broadcast position at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, where the Arkansas Tech Golden Suns lead Henderson State 28-25. Let's take a look at the halftime numbers. Henderson State 8 of 31 from the field, 26%. This from Moretti's team that came into the night second in the conference in scoring at 72.4 points per game. And the Golden Suns have pretty well shut them down so far. Henderson State has connected on 4 of 9 tries from three-point range. That's 44%. And Henderson State is 5 of 6, 83% at the free throw line. Arkansas Tech, 10 of 31 from the field, 32%, including just 1 out of 6 from three-point range. That is not surprising. Three-point shooting is not the strength of this Golden Suns team. Arkansas Tech is 7 of 12, 58%. From the free throw line. One of the strengths of this Golden Suns team all year long has been rebounding. That has continued tonight. Arkansas Tech out rebounding Henderson State so far, 27-21. And the Golden Suns, with 11 offensive rebounds, have a 12-5 edge in second chance points. Arkansas Tech with 2 assists and 9 turnovers. Henderson State has 3 assists and 10 turnovers. Individual leaders first for Henderson State. Olivia Allen leads all scorers with 10 points. 4 points at halftime for J.J. Eddins. Jada Pickens and Sam Basson have 3 points apiece. Also 3 points for Brindley Huggins. And Bobby Basil has 2 points for Henderson State. Noteworthy that Tori Gittins and Ashley Farrar have combined for 0 points so far. They account for about 27 points a night between them for Henderson State. And so far, the Golden Suns have been able to hold Gittins and Farrar scoreless. And if that continues, that certainly bodes well for Arkansas Tech. But Farrar missed most of the first half due to foul trouble. And so we will see Henderson State's all-time leading scorer again to begin the third quarter. And we'll see what she's able to do for the Reddies in the second half. Individual leaders among very balanced scoring for Arkansas Tech. Alex Hill has 6 points and 3 rebounds. 4 points, 7 rebounds for Julie Wagner. Clara Grace Prater with 4 points in the first half for the Golden Suns. Then it's Jackie Rollins, along with Shelley Butler, Dana Thompson, and Haley Weirich with 3 points apiece. Thompson, in addition to her 3 points, also has 5 rebounds. 2 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists at halftime for Maissa Marsal, and that wraps up the scoring for Arkansas Tech with the Golden Suns in front, 28-25. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we will step aside for 2 minutes and then come back with a look at the GAC Women's Basketball Scoreboard. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back with you from the Alathus Realty broadcast position at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, with Arkansas Tech leading our women's game 28-25 over Henderson State at halftime. Let's take a look at scores from elsewhere in Great American Conference women's basketball tonight. Harding 64, UA Monticello 51 at Rhodes Reeves Fieldhouse in Searcy, as it has been Aubrey Isbell with 18 points tonight for the Harding Lady Bisons to lead the way there. In the fourth quarter in Arkadelphia, the news is not good. Ouachita Baptist has rallied to take a 66-57 lead over Southern Arkansas, behind 28 points from Madeline Tipton tonight, as Ouachita Baptist keeping its GAC tournament hopes alive if they can hang on and win that game. In Shawnee, it is Oklahoma Baptist 68 and Southeastern Oklahoma State 57. In Alva, it is Southern Nazarene 42 and Northwestern Oklahoma State 37, as the Crimson Storm tries to clinch the GAC Women's Basketball regular season championship outright. And with 5 minutes and 24 seconds left in Weatherford, it is East Central 41 and Southwestern Oklahoma State 38 in that ball game between the Tigers and the Lady Bulldogs. Here at the Olathus Realty broadcast position, we will step aside for 1 minute and then come back with the second half. The Golden Suns lead 28-25. This is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network. Back with you from the Olathus Realty broadcast position at John E. Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. Arkansas Tech 28 and Henderson State 25 as we begin the third quarter. Glad you are with us tonight on the EAB Sports Network. We will be rejoining KCJC 102.3 FM pretty soon, as the Russellville High School game from the 5A state tournament is down to 12 seconds left. And the Cyclones down by four and not looking good for the Crimson Cyclones right now, as Lake Hamilton in possession and going to the foul line, up by four with 8 seconds left. And so it looks like the Russellville High School boys season may come to an end tonight in Searcy. But what an outstanding year it has been for that group of young men. And the Lady Cyclones won earlier today, and so their season will continue on into the second round of the state tournament tomorrow. Here in Russellville, Henderson State with the basketball to begin the third quarter. Drive by Brinley Huggins, and Brinley Huggins knocks down the 12-foot jumper from inside the painted area, and that's how the third quarter begins. The Huggins back bucket cuts the Arkansas Tech lead to 28-27. Clara Grace Prater, left-handed dribble drive to the free throw line, throws it out to Marsall. Maissa draws a double team, steps through it, lays it up, missed it, no good. Rebound off Marsall, out of bounds, and the basketball belongs to Henderson State with 9 minutes and 30 seconds to go. It'll be Olivia Allen to bring it up for the Reddies. Allen goes to the top of the key, hands it off to Huggins. Left-handed dribble drive, feeds Basil, layup good. Henderson State has scored the first 4 points of the third quarter, and just like that, the Reddies go in front 29-28. Prater with the answer. Clara Grace comes swooping in from the left wing, lays it in from the right side of the hoop, and Arkansas Tech goes back in front 30-29. Now a steal by Julie Wagner off a deflection by Maissa Marsall. Suns the other way, up by one with 9 minutes left in the third quarter. Alex Hill dribbles right, defended by Huggins, spins, goes in for the layup, probably got fouled, no whistle. Offensive rebound, Thompson. Thompson gives to Wagner. Wagner misses the jumper from the left baseline. Dana is shaken up. She's able to get back to her feet, though. Henderson State playing 5-on-4 right now. Gittins with it on the left baseline, throws it out to Farrar. Farrar drives, gets to the rim, layup good for Ashley Farrar. First 2 points of the night for Farrar. Come with 8 minutes and 34 seconds remaining in the third quarter. They give Henderson State a 31-30 lead. And McKenna Winans and J.J. Eddins are in place of Basil and Gittins for Henderson State. And Alex Hill, Maisa Marsall, Dana Thompson, Clara Grace Prater, and Julie Wagner go back to work offensively for the Golden Suns, with Arkansas Tech trailing by one, 8:25 left in the third. Golden Suns trying to clinch their 18th consecutive postseason berth with a win here tonight. There's a steal off an errant pass. Farrar got it for the Reddies. Ahead on the fast break for Allen. Poked away from her, out of bounds. And the Reddies will maintain with 8:15 to go in the third. Henderson State leading 31-30. Final score from the 5A state tournament. Lake Hamilton 55 and the Russellville boys 52. And so Russellville High School's boys basketball season comes to an end tonight in the first round of the 5A state tournament. We'll rejoin radio coverage momentarily on KCJC 102.3 FM. Three-point try, no good from the left wing for Olivia Allen. Defensive rebound, Arkansas Tech. Suns into the front court. Pass out on the left wing for Alex Hill. Hill drives, spins, gets to the rim, layup too strong off the glass. Defensive rebound, McKenna Winans. Readies the other way. Allen gets to the free throw line, throws it out left side for Farrar, deflected out by Alex Hill. And Henderson State will throw it in from the near sideline. Inbound pass to Farrar. Farrar dribbles right, goes down the right side of the lane, and a whistle and a foul is committed by Arkansas Tech. And it'll be two free throws for Ashley Farrar. The foul on the Golden Suns is the third personal on Dana Thompson. Team foul number one this quarter.
It's her third.
And to the free throw line goes Farrar. Ashley Farrar's first free throw is up and short, no good for Farrar, who is a career 80% free throw shooter. Farrar has reached double figures in scoring 22 times this year. In her career, she scored 20 or more on 36 occasions. She makes the second free throw, 7:39 to go in the third. And it is now a 32-30 lead for the Reddies. Arkansas Tech into the front court. Drive, layup try, no good. Offensive rebound by Julie Wagner. Throws it out, and it's stolen away by Henderson State. Reddies in transition. Farrar to the basket. Layup up and good for Ashley Farrar, who has asserted herself to begin the third quarter. And Dave Wilbers wants timeout. 7 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the third quarter. It is Henderson State 34 and Arkansas Tech 30. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we step aside for 1 minute. You're listening to the Golden Suns on the EAB Sports Network.
About you and your family, and was passionate about taking care of you. That is the philosophy of everyone who works here at A Better Way Realty. We want your business because we earn it, period. Discover what experience and heart can do with A Better Way Realty. Find us on Facebook and see the difference. A Better Way Realty. Real estate done a better way.
We welcome our audience joining us on KCJC 102.3 FM. Turnaround jumper from the right block is no good for Dana Thompson.
Arkansas Tech University basketball.
And the Golden Suns get back on defense now. Top to the key for Winans. Pass to the left side for Ashley Farrar. Farrar wants to drive, throws it out front for Winans. Now a pass to Brindley Huggins. Huggins drives, left-handed layup up and good for Brindley Huggins. 7 points for Huggins and a 36-30 lead for Henderson State as the Reddies have outscored the Golden Suns by a margin of 11-2 over the first 3.5 minutes of the third quarter. Prater misses from the right baseline. Defensive rebound, Brindley Huggins, and Henderson State the other way with all kinds of momentum. Pass out to the right side for Huggins. Huggins dribbles left, gets by Dana Thompson, feeds it down low for Winans. Layup up and good for McKenna Winans. Winans with her first 2 points, and Coach Dave Wilbers wants another timeout. 6:18 to go in the third. Henderson State leads 38-30. And as our radio audience joins us, we say hello to our friends on KCJC 102.3 FM. Welcome to Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. We thank you for joining us and staying with us after the Russellville High School game has wrapped up from Searcy. And we certainly pass along our congratulations to head coach Greg Chenault and the Cyclones on an outstanding season, which came to an end tonight at the 5A state tournament. And now as you join us at Tucker Coliseum, 6 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the third quarter, Henderson State 38, Arkansas Tech 30. The Golden Suns led this game 28-25 at halftime, but Henderson State has come out and made 6 of its first 7 field goal tries to begin the third quarter, while the Golden Suns are just 1 of 6 from the field so far in this third quarter. And Henderson State, on a 13-2 run to begin the third quarter, leads Arkansas Tech now 38-30. What's on the line tonight for the Golden Suns? It's their final home game, and it's a chance to clinch a berth in the Great American Conference Tournament. The Golden Suns trying to make it to the postseason for an 18th consecutive year. But it's not going to be easy now, as Henderson State has found its sea legs after the Reddies struggled mightily to shoot the basketball in the first half. Henderson State, 86% from the field over the first 3 minutes and 42 seconds of this third quarter. And now following the timeout, as Coach Dave Wilbers has had to call 2 timeouts in rapid succession, the basketball belongs to the Golden Suns, down by 8. And this is the largest lead that Henderson State has had all night. Maissa Marsall, Clara Grace Prater, Shelley Butler, Julie Wagner, and Haley Weirich are the 5 for Arkansas Tech. Marsall goes right, defended by Eddins, lost the basketball as the help defender Olivia Allen took it away from her. It results in a held ball between Allen and Marsall. Possession arrow favors the Golden Suns. And Arkansas Tech will throw it in from the baseline. It'll be Maissa Marsall to throw it in. Marsall looking. Lobs it out to the top of the key for Clara Grace Prater. Prater, defended by Huggins, dribbles left. Clara Grace still with the bounce, passes right wing to Weirich. Haley Weirich dribbles left to the right elbow. Picks it up there, lobs it for Shelley Butler. Layup is good, and a foul. Shelley Butler looked like she was too far underneath the goal, but with great flexibility was able to lean back and somehow get that thing to go, and she also drew the foul. The foul on Henderson State is going to be team foul number 1 this quarter, as Butler's free throw is good. She completes the 3-point play. The foul not registered yet in the official stats. And so we'll try to catch up on that in a moment. But nonetheless, the 3-point play for Shelley Butler cuts the Henderson State lead to 38-33. Left wing, ball possessed by Huggins, shovels it out to J.J. Eddins. Eddins dribbles right. Picked up there by Prater. Bounce pass in the wing for Allen. Olivia Allen across to Farrar. Farrar drives, 7 on the shot clock. Bobbled it for a moment. Got it back. Fadeaway jumper. No good. Defensive rebound by Julie Wagner of Arkansas Tech. 9th rebound of the night for Wagner. Marsall ahead to Butler. Shelley gathers the basketball. Throws it back out right wing for Maissa. Now to Weirich at the top of the key. Fakes the 3. Dribbles left. Hand off Prater. Prater drives. Spins. Shoots and misses from 10 feet. Defensive rebound by McKenna Winans of Henderson State. Winans with her 8th rebound of the game. Feed at the high post for Winans. She passes left baseline for Eddins. Out to Huggins. On to Farrar. Farrar back to Huggins. Open look at 3 is no good. Rebound tipped out by Weirich, but controlled for Henderson State by Allen. Allen for 3. It is no good. Defensive rebound, Shelley Butler. Outlet pass for Haley Weirich. Suns down by 5. 4:41 left in the third. Weirich dribbles to the top of the key, guarded there by Olivia Allen. Passes to Prater. Clara Grace defended for Henderson State by Huggins. Goes right. Passes to Wagner. Julie wants to drive. The runner from the right baseline, no good. Wagner gets her own rebound and puts it home. Julie Wagner with her 10th rebound of the night and the second chance points. Arkansas Tech has scored the last 5 points, and Shelley Butler is hobbled. Butler will have to check out with 4:23 left in the third quarter. And assistant coach Brad Palmer will help her back behind the bench, where Duke Walden, the head athletic trainer at Arkansas Tech, will tend to Shelley Butler. Here with 4:23 left in the third, and the Henderson State lead cut to 38-35. Olivia Allen will bring it up for the Reddies. Allen kept Henderson State in this game with 10 first half points. She gets it back from Farrar, passes right side to Eddins. Eddins dribbles left, falls down, but maintained her dribble. Gives it up to Gittins. Gittins on to Farrar, deflected by Dana Thompson, stolen by Clara Grace Prater. Prater with Marsall on her left, goes to the rim, layup no good. Defensive rebound, Gittins, and a foul committed by Arkansas Tech. Looked like Haley Weirich got her. It is going to be team foul number 2 this quarter on the Golden Suns.
I think Marsall got
it. Oh, they called it on Maissa. It would have been just the first on Weirich. It was wishful thinking by me. Instead, it is the third personal foul on Maissa Marsall with 3:55 to go in the third. Tori Gittins gives it out front to Eddins. Eddins to the high post for Winans. Out to the left side for Farrar. Farrar goes right. Gives it up out front for Allen. Olivia Allen back to Farrar. Farrar dribbles on the right wing. A deep three-pointer is off to the left. Defensive rebound by Julie Wagner. 11 rebounds on the night for Wagner. And the Golden Suns back to work offensively. Down by 3. Out front for Marsall. Pass to the left wing for Haley Weirich. Weirich gives to Dana Thompson. Thompson in the paint. Throws it out to Wagner. 18-footer is short. Offensive rebound, Dana Thompson. And they take her to the floor. A whistle and a foul called against Henderson State. The pushing foul is team foul number 2 this quarter on the Reddies. As Bobby Basil will check back in for Henderson State. Foul was on McKenna Winans. It's her second. Correction, 3 on Winans now. And with 3:19 to go in the third and Henderson State leading 38-35, the Golden Suns throw it in to Prater. 15-footer, no good. Offensive rebound, Julie Wagner. Wagner throws it out right side for Weirich. Weirich backs her defender down. It's J.J. Eddins. Throws it out to the left wing, deflected out of bounds by Tori Gittins. And Arkansas Tech will maintain possession with 12 on the shot clock. Clara Grace Prater will throw it in from the far sideline. Inbound pass to Maissa Marsall. Marsall guarded out front by Tori Gittins. Shot clock at 8. Marsall drives, gives left baseline for Wagner. Out to Prater for 3. No good. Rebound tipped around. Weirich got it. Offensive rebound, Haley Weirich. Throws it out front for Maissa Marsall. Gives to Thompson. Left elbow jumper. Too strong. Defensive rebound for Henderson State by Bobby Basil. And Arkansas Tech is 3 out of 14 from the field in this third quarter. J.J. Eddins' left-handed dribble and an arm bar foul against Maissa Marsall. And that is the fourth foul on Marsall with 2:37 left in the third. And here comes Alex Hill to check into the game in place of Marsall. Maissa checks out with 2 points, 4 rebounds, and 2 assists. Inbound for Olivia Allen. Allen passes right wing to Farrar. Farrar back to Allen on the right baseline. Olivia Allen guarded by Haley Weirich. Left-handed dribble drive, lost the ball in the paint, and it's stolen by Dana Thompson of Arkansas Tech. Turnover number 13 for Henderson State. Golden Suns are plus 1 on the turnover margin. Left side to Weirich. Feeds it into the post for Julie Wagner. Wagner back out to Dana Thompson. Thompson drives, shoots over 2 defenders, missed it. Rebound, fought for. Wagner gets it out to Weirich. 3 to tie is good. Haley Weirich with the 3-pointer from the left wing with 2:03 left in the third. And the Golden Suns have rattled off 8 unanswered points to tie the score at 38. Out front to Tori Gittins. Gittins still scoreless on the night. They give it out front to Farrar. Farrar wants to drive, cut off by 2 defenders. Left side to Eddins. Eddins dribbles right. 12-footer in the lane, no good. Rebound, Henderson State. Eddins able to get her own. Out to Allen. Allen dribbles right. 5 on the shot clock, puts it up, no good. Defensive rebound for Arkansas Tech by Julie Wagner. Suns the other way with a chance to regain the lead. Pass to the left wing for Weirich. Weirich, right-handed dribble drive, gets to the right side of the paint. Lobs it out to the top of the key for Prater. Prater gets a pick from Dana Thompson. Goes right, passes to Weirich. Weirich wants a ball screen from Wagner, gets it, goes left. Three-pointer is not there this time. Wagner with the putback, good, and a foul. 10 straight points for the Golden Suns and a two-point lead with 109 to go in the third. And Julie Wagner going to the free throw line with a chance to make it a 41-38 game. And what a surge we have seen from the Golden Suns. One of the few times, Kelly, this year that I've seen the Golden Suns just totally discombobulated there early in this third quarter, and my, oh, my, how they have bounced back.
Yeah, they've kept fighting on the defensive end and getting those offensive rebounds, and Julie Wagner just playing the lights out right now.
A lot of it has been on the back of Julie Wagner's rebounding. She has 14 rebounds on the night. She completes the three-point play with the free throw, and now a blocking foul on Arkansas Tech's Clara Grace Prater. Prater's first personal foul. And it is team foul number four this quarter, so no free throws yet for Henderson State. Inbound right corner for J.J. Edens. Edens dribbles left, guarded by Prater, takes her into the lane. Lobs it out right wing for Brinley Huggins. Bounce pass to Farrar. Farrar drives the right side of the paint and lays it in. Ashley Farrar has scored all 7 of her points here in this third quarter, and she cuts the Arkansas Tech lead to 41-40. Right side for Clara Grace Prater. Prater defended by Pickens, goes left, gives to Alex Hill on the left wing. 20 on the shot clock as Hill drives, throws it out to Julie Wagner. Wagner on to Prater, top of the key. 27 seconds left in the third quarter. Shot clock at 8. Wagner sets a ball screen, Prater drives, spins, shoots, and misses. Rebound, put back, Dana Thompson, no good. Defensive rebound, Pickens. 15 seconds left in the third, Suns by 1. Pass across to Farrar, on to Huggins, back to Farrar. Farrar guarded by Alex Hill, 7 seconds left in the third. Farrar drives, 12-footer good for Ashley Farrar. 9 points for Farrar, 2.6 seconds left in the third, and the Golden Suns can't get it in bounds, and so that's the end of the third period, and we are set up for a great finish at Tucker Coliseum in this final home game of the year for the Golden Suns. It's Henderson State 42, Arkansas Tech 41. From the Olathe's Realty broadcast position, we pause for 1 minute. This is Golden Suns basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
Johnny Story in with a thought from Olathe's Realty. With years of experience, knowledge, and a network of relationships, they ensure you'll get the most for your house. So when it comes time to put that property on the market or begin looking for that next dream home you have, don't delay. Call Brent Preddy and the professionals at Olathe's Realty Russellville, 968-5668, or check them out, russellvilleliving.com.
Mr. Brake and Lube wants you to know when it comes to your engine, not all motor oils are created equal. That's why they only offer name brand motor oils that you can trust, like Pennzoil, Castrol, Mobil 1, and more. So don't pay top dollar for cheap generics. Mr. Brake and Lube can work your vehicle pretty much bumper to bumper, plus complete auto glass service. So call 219-5438 or visit 1415 East Main Street. Mr. Brake and Lube, your one-stop maintenance shop.
Henderson State 42, Arkansas Tech 41 as we go to the fourth quarter in Russellville, and we check with Kelly for an update from the GAC women's basketball scoreboard.
Three finals for you. It is Southern Nazarene 60, Northwest Oklahoma 47. So Southern Naz stays in first place at 20-1 in the conference. Harding at 18-3 with their 75-60 victory over UA Monticello tonight. Northwest Oklahoma will remain in third place at 15-6 on the year. And Henderson State will, depending on the outcome tonight, they are at 13-7. So we'll see. They will remain in fourth position no matter what, win or lose tonight. So there's the three finals for you. And the others, too, are getting very close, and we'll pass those along. And here's one final, East Central 53, Southwest Oklahoma 51.
Here in Russellville, we begin the fourth quarter. Henderson State 42, Arkansas Tech 41. The Reddies are locked into the number 4 seed in the GAC tournament as Pickens shoots and misses from the right side. Offensive rebound, Edens. The Golden Suns need a win to get into the field for the GAC tournament March 7th through the 10th in Shawnee, Oklahoma. Left-handed dribble drive by Pickens, feeds Basil, layup up and good for Bobby Basil. She has 6 points, 9:35 to go in the fourth, and Henderson State now has scored the last 6 points to surge in front, 44-41. It has been a second half of runs both ways. Golden Suns trying to start one right here. Drive to the right baseline by Prater, cut off by Farrar. She gives to Alex Hill. Hill to the basket, layup up and good. 8 points for Alex Hill, 9:15 to go in the fourth. And it's a one-point lead for Henderson State. Pickens passes left wing for Farrar. Farrar across the top of the key to Brindley Huggins. Huggins guarded by Alex Hill. Gives the high post for Farrar out to Eddins. Eddins dribbles left. Gets inside the lane. 12-foot jumper, no good. Defensive rebound, Dana Thompson. Golden Suns will go the other way with a chance to regain the lead. Alex Hill over the timeline. Suns playing without Maissa Marsall right now, who is on the bench with four personal fouls. Dribbling right, pass to Alex Hill, feed into the post for Julie Wagner, and she was pushed from behind. Ashley Farrar arguing that Wagner was clearing her out, but they're going to call the foul on Henderson State anyway. It'll be the first team foul this period on the Reddies.
That's Farrar's third.
And it is going to be Tori Gittins checking in for the Reddies in place of J.J. Eddins. Inbound pass to be made by Alex Hill for the Golden Suns. Tech down by one, 8:38 to go. Right wing, Haley Wyrick goes left, defended by Gittins. Gets a pick from Wagner, throws it out top of the key for Prater. Prater with 8:27 to play. Nine on the shot clock, across to Alex Hill. Hill wants to drive the baseline, defended by Pickens. Leans in, shot up, short, no good. Nice defense by Pickens to force the miss. And Bobby Basil got the defensive rebound. Huggins wide open for three. No good from the right wing. Rebound tipped out. And Clara Grace Prater gathers it for Arkansas Tech. 8 minutes remaining. Henderson State 44, Arkansas Tech 43 from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville. Prater drives. Prater spins. Prater shoots. Prater misses. Rebound out of bounds. And a whistle and a pushing foul on Henderson State. Bobby Basil is the guilty party. It is Basil's third. As Jackie Rollins checks in and Haley Wyrick checks out for Arkansas Tech, Farrar and Basil are out for the Reddies as Winans returns for Henderson State. McKenna Winans, J.J. Eddins, Brindley Huggins, Jada Pickens, and Tori Gittins now the five for Henderson. Inbound for Clara Grace Prater. Prater dribbles right into the lane, gets by Pickens but can't finish the shot. And the defensive rebound is cleared for Henderson State by McKenna Winans, as Winans gets her ninth rebound of the game. Reddies into the front court, leading by one, 7:36 to go. Pickens dribbles left, guarded by Clara Grace Prater. Pass to Huggins. Huggins dribbling. Passes top of the key to Eddins. Eddins goes right. Gets around Prater. Prater tries to recover and block her shot, but there's a whistle and a foul against Arkansas Tech. The foul on the Golden Suns is going to be team foul number one this quarter. It is the second personal foul on Clara Grace Prater. And J.J. Eddins will step to the free throw line for Henderson State with 7:23 remaining and the Reddies up by one. Both teams one out of four from the field so far in this fourth quarter. It's definitely been a game that's been dominated by the two defenses. Arkansas Tech is shooting 29% from the field. Henderson State shooting 34% from the field. Eddins goes one out of two, missing the second one. Dana Thompson with her easiest rebound of the season. And the Golden Suns will go the other way, down by two with 7:16 remaining in the ball game. Pass to the high post for Julie Wagner. Back out to the right wing for Clara Grace Prater. Now Thompson makes a catch at the top of the key. Dana surveys the defense, passes left wing to Alex Hill. Touch pass to Wagner, layup up and good for Julie Wagner. It's a double-double for Julie Wagner. She's got 11 points and 14 rebounds, 6:55 remaining. Score tied at 45, but not for long. On the other end, Brindley Huggins hits a three from the right wing, and Henderson State calls timeout. 6 minutes and 48 seconds to go in Russellville. Henderson State 48, Arkansas Tech 45. From the Alathus Realty broadcast position, we step aside for 1 minute. This is Golden Suns basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
If you pay for your own health insurance or you're looking for coverage, do not go online for quotes. You'll get endless calls from call centers and they will not stop. Instead, call Becky, the health plan lady. She can provide sound advice for your health insurance needs. Her Freedom of Choice plans lets you pick your doctors, no deductibles, no copays, and it's 30 to 60% lower cost than Obamacare. Call Becky at 479-886-2475 or go to healthplanlady.com.
ABC Children's Academy is currently enrolling with 14 locations in Pope, Johnson, and Yell County. ABC provides all-day child care, as well as a variety of enrollment options for families, including Arkansas Better Chance for ages 3 to 5, plus more. Visit abcchildrensacademy.com for more info and come by their central office on 4th Street in Russellville to apply in person or call 567-5650. ABC Children's Academy, changing our world one student at a time.
A very good crowd filing into Tucker Coliseum on the occasion of this final home game of the year. There's still room for you and still time if you're in the area to come on out and enjoy the Wonder Boys game coming up at approximately, oh goodness, it's going to be pushing 8 o'clock or a little bit later before that game gets on the floor. And so you've still got time to come out and support the Wonder Boys as they pursue their 22nd regular season conference championship in men's basketball. We're set up for a fine finish here in the women's game. Henderson State leading 48-45, 6:39 to go. Golden Suns with the ball. Pass to the top of the key for Dana Thompson. Floats it down low for Wagner. Back out to Dana. Three to tie is good! Dana Thompson with the three-pointer from the top of the key with 6:27 remaining. And the Golden Suns have tied it at 48. Huggins this time cannot answer. Defensive rebound, Julie Wagner. Golden Suns the other way. That was Dana Thompson's third career three-pointer, and it ties it at 48 with now 6:11 to go.
Came at a good time.
Feed down low for Dana Thompson. Turnaround, out of control, no good. Defensive rebound, J.J. Eddins, and Henderson State goes the other way. 6 minutes left, tied at 48. Feed for Winans. Stripped loose and stolen. Dana Thompson makes the play for Arkansas Tech, and the Golden Suns with a chance to regain the lead with 5:49 to play. Alex Hill goes to the left side, hands it off to Clara Grace Prater. Prater goes right, gets a pick from Wagner. Wagner tries to get open in the post. They throw it out front for Hill. Alex drives, spins, gets to the front of the rim, and makes the layup. Alex Hill with 10 points. She's into double figures and scoring for the 35th time as a Golden Sun, and she gives Arkansas Tech a 50-48 lead.
All right, let's go defense. Let's pick it up here.
Pass deflected out of bounds. Henderson State will throw it in from the far sideline with approximately... Right now they say for sure 22 on the shot clock. We had some clock malfunctions in the first half, and they've had to go to a handheld shot clock. And Hans Heaton, our shot clock keeper, is keeping it on a stopwatch and then is announcing it over the PA system at appropriate times. Bounce pass to the right side for Brindley Huggins. Huggins throws it to the left side for Pickens. Pickens gets into the lane, kicks it out right side for Ashley Farrar. Farrar jab step, gives it out front to Eddins. Eddins goes right, three to shoot. Deep three by Farrar is an air ball, out of bounds. Farrar arguing the Golden Suns deflected it. The officials do not agree, and the basketball belongs to Arkansas Tech with 5 minutes and 5 seconds to go, and the Suns leading 50-48. Into the front court for Julie Wagner. Finds Prater cutting the basket. Eight-footer in the lane is no good. Rebound, Henderson State. Jada Pickens gets it. Pickens over the timeline. Gives left side to Farrar. Farrar guarded by Prater. Out front for Huggins. Left-handed dribble drive. Running 10-footer, no good. Defensive rebound again by Julie Wagner. They foul her. Team foul number three this quarter on Henderson State. And it'll be the Golden Suns ball with 4:41 to go.
Eddins? No, Huggins.
Brindley Huggins, third personal foul. And for the first time tonight for the Golden Suns, it is Sarah Edmondson, a 6-foot sophomore forward from Flower Mound, Texas, 1.7 points and 3.5 rebounds per game. Edmondson did not play at Southwestern or Northwestern Oklahoma State last week. Marsall is back in for the Suns. She drives, out of control shot, rebound Henderson State. And a technical foul. A technical foul called on Maissa Marsall, and that'll be the end of the night for Maissa. She said something to the official, felt like she got fouled on that shot. And she said something that the official did not like. And so Maissa Marsall will foul out of this game with 4 minutes and 27 seconds to go. And not the way the senior wanted to go out in her final home game.
Oh, tough one.
Ashley Farrar will take the technical foul shots for Henderson State. Farrar is a career 80% free throw shooter. She is 10th in the Great American Conference in free throw percentage this year. Farrar shooting 80% from the line. First try is up and good for Farrar, who is appearing in her 125th game as a Ready tonight, made her 87th start for Henderson State.
What a career.
Made the first one, made the second one, and the two technical foul shots.
Plus they get the ball.
Tie the score at 50. And now a chance for the Reddies to regain the lead. Jada Pickens will bring it up. Guarded by Alex Hill. Golden Sun show 2-3 zone. Pass to Farrar. Farrar dribbles left, gives it out to Huggins. Huggins bounce pass to Farrar. Cross court right wing to Pickens. Pickens able to get it out to Huggins. Now Farrar. Farrar left wing, wants to drive, gets into the lane. Running scoop shot, no good. Defensive rebound by Sarah Edmondson. Score remains tied at 50 with 4:03 to go. Clara Grace right side to Hill. Alex three for the lead is good. Nothing but net from the right wing for Alex Hill. She's got 13 points and the Suns lead 53-50 with 3:50 to go.
Come on, defense.
Alex Hill has scored the Golden Suns' last 5 points. I told you, she's a money player. Pickens from 10 feet shoots and scores. Jada Pickens has 5 points. 3:39 to go. Suns lead is cut to one at 53-52. Alex Hill passes right wing to Clara Grace Prater. Back to Hill. 20 on the shot clock. Hill drives, runs over Farrar, whistle, and a blocking foul. It'll be two shots. They're going to call the foul on the floor.
It'll be her fourth.
Actually, they're going to call it, they're going to say she was in the act of shooting. She was in the act of shooting, so it'll be two shots. And Kelly, you are exactly right. That is four on Ashley Farrar. It is team foul number four. Farrar will check out, replaced by Olivia Allen. And Alex Hill to the free throw line for Arkansas Tech. Alex is 0 for 3 at the line so far this evening. First try on its way and good. She was able to coax it over the front of the iron and through. 14 points for Alex Hill. And now she will shoot for her 15th. With 3 minutes and 24 seconds to go, the second free throw is nothing but net. Alex Hill has now scored the Golden Suns' last 7 points.
Keep it up, defense. Here
and
we go.
55-52 Golden Suns with 3:16 to go. A win by Arkansas Tech puts the Golden Suns into the postseason for an 18th consecutive year. Huggins misses the three. Defensive rebound, Alex Hill. Suns the other way, up by three with 3:03 to go. Hill stops at the top of the key, hands it off to Wyrick. Haley Wyrick dribbles on the left wing, goes right, pulls up, 15-footer, good! Off the dribble, Haley Wyrick connects from 15 feet at the right elbow extended, and the Suns lead 57-52. Jumper up and no good for Pickens. Rebound fought for. Clara Grace Prater playing with one shoe now, dive for the loose ball. A held ball is called, and Clara Grace with one shoe able to tie it up, and the possession arrow will give it to Arkansas Tech with 2:39 to go, and the Golden Suns on a 7-2 run.
Man, couldn't script it any better right now.
Clara Grace,
we can keep it going.
Clara Grace will get a moment to put her shoe back on and tie it.
Is some new shoes she's got on there?
I think she's been wearing those a little while.
Big game green shoes.
I'll say this. You and I would probably need a fashion consultant to be able to keep track of the shoes.
That's probably true.
Neither one of us are qualified in that area.
A lot of truth to that.
Alex Hill, Clara Grace Prater, Dana Thompson, Julie Wagner, and Haley Wyrick. Suns by five, 2:32 to go. Pass to the right wing for Alex Hill. Hill guarded by Allen, gives it out front to Dana Thompson. Thompson passes left wing. Prater with the ball. Clara Grace dribbles right, gets downhill, layup is good for Clara Grace Prater with 2 minutes and 19 seconds to go. It's a 9-2 run for the Golden Suns, and they lead it 59-52. Pass to the right wing for Huggins. Huggins passes in the corner for Allen. Back out to Huggins. Bounce pass to Pickens. Pickens throws left side for Eddins. Eddins defended by Hill and Thompson. Looks to drive, and a foul is called against Arkansas Tech as the official says Dana put two hands on her.
Two hands.
And that is the fourth personal foul on Dana Thompson.
Got to be careful. Still got to play good defense, though.
Speaking of four fouls, Ashley Farrar is back in the game for Henderson State. They have not gone to Tori Gittins much here in this one. She has been held scoreless tonight. Inbound for Pickens. Pickens goes right, gets to the rim, layup up, no good. Rebound, tipped around. Pickens gets it for Henderson State. A minute 48 left. Suns by seven. Winans, right baseline jumper, no good. Rebound, Arkansas Tech. Dana Thompson with her 11th rebound of the night. Into the front court come the Golden Suns with a minute 37 to go. And Arkansas Tech leading 59-52. And the Golden Suns clinching it, or closing in on a berth in Shawnee. Clara Grace Prater defended by Olivia Allen. A minute 23 to go. Prater goes right. Prater sees a seam. Scoop shot. Good. And a foul. Ashley Farrar has fouled out of the game. And the Golden Suns are up by nine with a minute 19 to go. Correction, they're not going to call it on Farrar. It doesn't appear. Looks like they're going to give it to Winans instead. They call it on McKenna Winans. That's just four on her. Looked like it could have been the fifth on Farrar. 1 minute and 19 seconds left, and Clara Grace Prater a chance to make it a 10-point game, which she does. Arkansas Tech on a 12-2 run over the last 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Allen drives, 10-footer, no good. Rebound, Winans, out to Pickens. Henderson State just 3 out of 15 from the field in this fourth quarter. Pickens for 3, in and out, no good. Farrar with the putback, it is no good. And a late, and I mean extremely late, whistle from the far side of the floor. And a foul against Arkansas Tech.
That was way late.
And Coach Dave Wilbers has to take a walk to the other end of the bench on that one.
Mercy sakes.
That was absolutely the old wait and see if it goes in.
I think there was already a rebound made. And then the whistle blew.
He waited to see if it went in or not, and when it didn't, that's when he called the foul.
Woo, mercy.
Absolutely. The foul was on Clara Grace Prater. It's her third. Farrar makes the first free throw for her 12th point of the night. 1 minute, 2 seconds to go. The second one is good, and it's 62-54. Golden Suns by 8. Full court pressure by Henderson State. Inbound pass to Alex Hill. Golden Suns having to play without their point guard here, Maissa Marsall. Hill into the front court, hands it off to Prater. Prater backs it out. Henderson State not looking to foul right now. 20 on the shot clock. 48 seconds left in the game. Henderson State still not looking to foul. Allen just guarding Prater closely. 42 seconds left. 10 on the shot clock. Going left, Prater. 6 on the shot clock. Prater feeds it for Hill. It's batted away by Pickens, stolen by Winans. Henderson State the other way, down by 8. 31 seconds left. Pickens out to Farrar. Three-pointer is good. With 26.7 seconds to go and timeout taken by Arkansas Tech. Golden Suns lead 62-57, 26.7 seconds to go. Back to the Elathus Realty broadcast position in 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
Well, the folks at Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air want to take just a moment to not only thank you for your business, but also the opportunity to work for you and give your family whole house comfort. You know, every kind word you put online, those personal recommendations to your friends and family are appreciated. Customers like you are not only vital to the business of Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air, but vital to making our community as great as it is. Special thanks from the folks at Arkansas River Valley Heating and Air.
26.7 seconds remaining. Arkansas Tech 62, Henderson State 57. One thing I want to mention. Dave Wilbers has won 354 games as the head women's basketball coach at Arkansas Tech. 355 is a very special number in the history of Arkansas Tech basketball. That's how many games Sam Heinzman won as the head men's basketball coach at Arkansas Tech. And the next time the Golden Suns win a game, be it tonight, be it Saturday at Magnolia, be it next week at the GAC tournament, Coach Wilbers will tie Coach Heinzman with 355 wins. And the only person in front of him in terms of head coaching wins in basketball at Arkansas Tech will be Joe Foley, who won 456 games with the Golden Suns from 1987 through 2003. 355 wins would be an awfully sweet celebration and a great way to get into the postseason. Inbound pass for Haley Weirich. And Jada Pickens fouls her with 25.8 seconds to go. The foul on Jada Pickens is her third personal foul. And Haley Weirich to the free throw line for Arkansas Tech. Weirich with 8 points tonight. This is her first free throw attempt of the game. It is on its way. It is good. Nothing but net for Haley Weirich, a career 67% free throw shooter. Now Weirich a chance to make it a three-possession game with 25.8 seconds left, which she does. Two clutch free throws for Haley Weirich and a 64-57 lead for the Golden Suns. 25.8 seconds remaining. Timeout Henderson State. Back to the Alathus Realty broadcast position in 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. We're more than just tires. Consistent, responsive, honest and fair. What makes us different? We're the ones who care. Trust our experience to know what you need. Professional and fast, see what we mean. Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. We're more than just tires.
Arkansas Tire and Auto Service. 2304 East Main, Russellville.
25.8 seconds left. Golden Suns by seven. Inbound pass to Pickens. Pickens guarded by Weirich. Pickens goes right. Gets Weirich into the lane. Throws it out to Winans. Right baseline jumper good for McKenna Winans with 14.9 seconds left. That cuts the Golden Suns lead to 64-59. And Arkansas Tech will use its final timeout back to the Alathus Realty broadcast position in 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
When it comes to buying or selling a home, there really is a better way. As soon as you start talking with our team at A Better Way Realty in Russellville, you're going to feel the difference. Imagine if you had a great friend in the real estate industry, someone who genuinely cared about you and your family and was passionate about taking care of you. That is the philosophy of everyone who works here at A Better Way Realty. We want your business because we earn it, period. Discover what experience and heart can do with A Better Way Realty. Find us on Facebook and see the difference. A Better Way Realty. Real estate done a better way.
Arkansas Tech has exhausted its supply of timeouts. Henderson State has two timeouts left. Golden Suns with the ball. Arkansas Tech leading 64-59. 15.2 seconds left. Inbound to Dana Thompson. Thompson is fouled with 13.5 seconds left. Henderson State got what it wanted there. They were trying to deny the basketball to everybody else and forced Dana Thompson, the career 56% free throw shooter, to receive that inbound pass. What they may not know about Dana is she hit two clutch free throws in a very similar spot at Ouachita Baptist here within just the last couple of weeks. The first free throw is good. Nothing but net for Dana Thompson. And now a chance to make it a three-possession game again with 13.5 seconds left. The second try for Dana Thompson is good. 66-59, Golden Suns by seven. Timeout Henderson State back to the Alathus Realty broadcast position in 30 seconds. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
Farmers Co-op located in Russellville. Don't forget their Danville location. Mike Apples along. Mike, it is that time of year when feed is very, very important.
It sure is, and make sure that you've got your animals' needs taken care of, protein levels met, and all those things that you look for when it comes this time of year.
Farmers Co-op, we're located on East Main in Russellville. Don't forget the Danville location.
13.5 seconds remaining. Arkansas Tech 66, Henderson State 59. Inbound pass to Olivia Allen. Hands it back to Farrar. Farrar defended by Alex Hill, and they call Alex for a foul. It's team foul number five, and so it'll be free throws for Farrar with 10.2 seconds left. Farrar has scored all 16 of her points here in the second half. And she will shoot two more free throws. She is 5 of 6 from the line tonight. Golden Suns need to remember they are out of timeouts here. First free throw good for Farrar. Now a second try forthcoming for the graduate student from Green Forest. It is good, 66-61, Suns by five. Clara Grace Prater to make the inbound pass. Gets it into Dana Thompson. Thompson far corner, throws it back to Prater. It's stolen by Pickens. 6 seconds left, Pickens misses the layup, but is fouled by Clara Grace Prater. And thank goodness that layup by Pickens did not go in.
Woo, mercy.
This could have got real sticky.
It may get real sticky anyway,
but the foul on Prater sends Pickens to the line for two shots. Pickens is 3 out of 4 from the free throw line tonight and an 85% free throw shooter on the year. The first one on its way and good for Jada Pickens as she gets her 6th point. 5.3 seconds remaining. It is on its way. It is good, and it's down to a one-possession game, 66-63 with 5.3 to go. Inbound
protect
to Dana Thompson. Thompson dribbling down the far sideline, and they foul her with 3.1 seconds left. And now we're down to a situation where Dana Thompson will shoot two free throws, and if she can make one of them, the Golden Suns are on their way to Shawnee.
Wouldn't it be a great way for our senior to go out?
Dana Thompson, the last time she will shoot a basketball in a game here at Tucker Coliseum, a chance to put it away.
You got to get ready if she misses both.
First free throw is good. It's good. And it's a four-point lead with 3.1 seconds to go. Arkansas Tech is 10 out of 10 from the free throw line in the second half, including 8 of 8 in the fourth quarter. That one's no good. Defensive rebound, Winans. And Henderson State calls timeout with 2.4 seconds remaining.
That way they can push the ball up to half court.
Arkansas Tech leading 67-63. And we'll check with Kelly real quick for an update from the GAC Women's Basketball Scoreboard.
And all the finals, Southern Nazarene 60, Northwest Oklahoma 47, Harding 75, UA Monticello 60. It was East Central 53, Southwest Oklahoma 51. That's a big win for us because that puts us in a tie for fifth now with Southwest Oklahoma. And Southern Arkansas falls to Ouachita 83-71. And it was Oklahoma Baptist 10 better than Southeast Oklahoma tonight, 70-60. So standing-wise, we are tied for fifth now with Southwest Oklahoma at 10-11. If we can pull 2.8 seconds off the clock here and come away with the win, what does that mean? That means Southwest Oklahoma, they go play Southern Nazarene on Saturday. So very good possibility we could, if we do what we need to do at Southern Arkansas on Saturday, we can end up in fifth place in the standings for the conference.
And
now,
guess
what does that mean?
Exactly.
We get to play Henderson State again.
Absolutely. That would be the matchup in the first round in Shawnee a week from Friday, if that's what comes to pass. 2.8 seconds left here. Golden Suns leading 67-63. Inbound pass to Olivia Allen. Do not foul her. Allen, a deep three at the buzzer. It is good, but it doesn't matter. The Golden Suns have won it. Final score from Tucker Coliseum is Arkansas Tech 67 and Henderson State 66. It's a win for the two seniors and their final appearance at Tucker Coliseum. It's an 18th consecutive postseason berth for the Golden Suns, and it is the 355th win of Dave Wilbur's career at Arkansas Tech, matching the total by the great Sam Heinzman when he was the head men's basketball coach at Tech from 1947 to 1966. Golden Suns win back in 30 seconds with Coach Wilbur's and the Health Plan Lady postgame show. This is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
Burris at Into Market reminds you that the new year is like spring, a season of change. And if your office furniture hasn't changed in a while or you need a total office remodel, Into Market provides expert advice to give you inspiration, plus products ranging from quality sophisticated furniture to more economical products for the builder, homeowner, architect, or designer. Into Market is your local dealer that offers professional furniture installation and delivery. Into Market, your make your office like new plus more store.
Back with you at the Alathus Realty broadcast position at Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, where the officials are for sure leaving the floor, and that means this game is officially over. They did go over and take a look at the monitor to make sure there was no time left after that ball went through the basket for Olivia Allen, and so it is officially now Arkansas Tech 67 and Henderson State 66 as the Golden Suns improve to 13-12 overall, 10-11 in the Great American Conference, and Arkansas Tech is going to the postseason in women's basketball for an 18th consecutive year as the Suns win it tonight by a final score of 67-66. And here on the Health Plan Lady Postgame Show, Dave Wilbers, head coach of the Golden Suns, is on his way over to discuss this, and Coach Wilbers offering his appreciation to the student section, which was certainly a factor in this game here tonight. And now we are joined by Dave Wilbers, head coach of the Golden Suns, after this 67-66 win tonight over Henderson State. And Coach, Henderson State came out and punched your team right in the mouth to start the third quarter. What was it that made the difference and allowed your team to come back and recover from that?
Well, they did punch us in the mouth, but I think we punched them back. I mean, they got a, you know, 8-point lead, but we never gave up, and I think our zone was the difference in the game. You know, we played a good tight zone, and players did a good job of just finding their shooters and just battling it out.
You talk about toughness. Tell me about 27 rebounds combined from Julie Wagner and Dana Thompson tonight.
Well, toughness.
Yeah.
And those two, their post players at Henderson are very physical, and those two stepped up to the challenge and did a fantastic job and just pulled down some big offensive rebounds. And the thing I liked about it, though, Sam, is we got the offensive rebounds, but we got good putbacks, too, and finished shots. So it was big.
Alex Hill has been a money player ever since she stepped on campus. When it gets down to this time of year, this is when Alex is at her best. She had 15 points, including some big buckets there in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, well, she's an experienced player and got off to a little slow start, but once she got her motor going, and, you know, Alex kept telling me she was cold, too. And, you know, it's 50 degrees in here. I'm cold, too. So, you know, finally got her going, but, yeah, she made some big shots and some big layups.
Another player I want to highlight was Clara Grace Prater. Clara Grace did not have her best shooting night of the year, and the old Clara Grace would have shut it down and stopped looking for her shot. But tonight she had the courage to stick with it and the stick to it, and she ends up scoring 11 points, and she also had some big buckets down the stretch.
Yeah, kept fighting through it, and you're right, that's where Clara has matured as a player. Just kept fighting through it and made some good plays, and, you know, probably played her best defensive night too tonight.
What does it mean to you to be going to the postseason now, all 17 of your years, 18 years in a row overall for the Golden Suns? What does it mean for this group to clinch a berth in Shawnee?
Well, I think it's been big because it's been tough. This has been the toughest league since I've been here in 17 years. And, I mean, you guys have sat through all the games. Every game seems like it's been close. It's been down to the last minute. And to make the GAC tournament is a, you know, that's something that's hard to do right now. Because there's so many good teams. But, you know, got another game left, and we'll go down to SAU and try to improve our seed.
Well, Coach, I'm a little bit of a student of the history of this place. And in 1947, President J.W. Hull hired a guy from Arkansas State Teachers College by the name of Sam Heinzman to come here and be our head men's basketball coach. And over the next 19 years, not only did Coach Heinzman win 355 games, he was significant, not only just popularizing basketball in this part of the state, in the entire state of Arkansas, one of the most significant figures in the history of basketball in this state. And tonight, you have tied him for career wins with 355.
Yeah.
What does it mean to you to be associated with a figure like Sam Heinzman?
Yeah, a great figure in Arkansas Tech history, one of the greatest Arkansas Tech Wonder Boys ever. Coaches, players, the decisions that he made to get things built were unbelievable. But I think it just really says I got a bunch of good players. Good assistants and good players, and that'll do it.
Well, and a pretty heck of a good head basketball coach. And, Coach, thank you. We've had a chance to see almost all those 355 wins, a bunch more still to come. But I'm going to tell you right now, that's significant right there.
It is. It is. And, I mean, you sat through the Northwest Oklahoma game. We played good.
Oh, yeah.
We played good the last four games and just need to go down, get on the bus, and go play SAU and keep it going.
We'll see you there.
All right, thanks, Sam.
That is Dave Wilbers, the head women's basketball coach at Arkansas Tech University, following a 67-66 win tonight over Henderson State that has clinched a berth in the postseason for the Arkansas Tech Golden Suns, who will play their final game of the regular season on Saturday at Southern Arkansas. And the Golden Suns will have a chance on Saturday to perhaps grab the number 5 seed in the GAC tournament, which begins a week from today at Fire Lake Arena in Shawnee, Oklahoma. Make your plans to make the just 3-hour. What? Yeah. Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah. Coach Wilbers just wanted to verify there. Yeah, you're in. Yep. So he didn't want to go tell his team the wrong thing. So, yep, the Golden Suns are in. And so with this win here tonight, Arkansas Tech is now clear of Ouachita Baptist by 2 games with just 1 game to go. And so that's how you know for sure that Arkansas Tech is in. The Golden Suns, 2 games clear of Ouachita with 1 to go. That's the math on that. And so Arkansas Tech into the postseason, and the Golden Suns win it tonight 67-66. Here on the Health Plan Lady Postgame Show, we will step aside for 3 minutes. If you are in the area, we encourage you to go to ArkansasTechSports.com, tickets. We are still 25 minutes away from tip-off for the men's game, and so still lots of time to come out here and support this Wonder Boys basketball team as they play their final home game of the year and try to take a step toward a possible conference championship. It's the Wonder Boys in 25 minutes. Golden Suns win. We'll break for 3 minutes and then come back with more on the Health Plan Lady Postgame Show. This is Arkansas Tech Basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
Taking care of families. That's what the folks at C&D Drugstore have been doing in historic downtown Russellville for more than six decades when it comes to all your pharmaceutical needs. When it comes to compounding special medicines, R.D. Walker and his staff are there to serve you. And most importantly, if you need delivery, if you need curbside pickup, you need C&D Drugstore on the corner of B and Commerce in downtown Russellville, a 60-year tradition.
At Centennial Bank, we believe serving our community goes beyond assisting with financial needs. We pride ourselves on being community connected and customer focused. Supporting our community starts with our employees. We enjoy rolling up our sleeves and helping make our community a better place. Our local bankers are a team that brings passion, pride, and dedication to our communities. That is why Centennial Bank is proud to support the place we call home. Centennial Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Are you working hard to feed your family on a budget? Visit Chicken Mart to get all your Crispitos, pizza sticks, restaurant quality chicken nuggets, strips, wings, and fries all in one stop, and lots of opportunity purchases that are so good they may never come back. Check out Chicken Mart in two convenient locations before you go grocery shopping and see what they have for your family. Chicken Mart's been serving the River Valley since 1983 and still going strong. Visit 1808 South Arkansas Avenue or 106 Weir Road in Russellville. Chicken Mart, your chicken and more store.
When you think of someone using meth, what comes to mind? Someone who looks malnourished, missing teeth or skin lesions? They're often seen as dangerous, reckless, or even violent, but that's not reality. There is no face of meth. It could be a brother, a cousin, a friend, anyone. While there are treatment options available, the best medicine is prevention. Just don't do it. If you or someone you know needs help, just go to meovermeth.org. Stop it before it starts. Choose Me Over Meth, sponsored by CSI Region 6 Prevention.
Are you looking for a great place to work that offers great pay and benefits, where you can make an impact in a safe, clean environment? ConAgra is looking for motivated, energetic people to join their team. ConAgra is recruiting industrial maintenance technicians to fill openings on all shifts. Positions start at $25.61 an hour plus a shift differential. Experience is required, so for immediate consideration, apply online at conagrabrands.com/careers. That's conagrabrands.com/careers. ConAgra is an equal opportunity employer.
Looking to expand without breaking the bank? Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings has been serving the River Valley for 7 years and counting. Only $99 down delivers select Burnett affordable buildings and 20% off CNH carports for not only carports, but for barns, sheds, and more. Let Duval's Affordable Portable Buildings create the extra space you need without breaking the bank. Visit Duval's Affordable Portable Building.com or just stop by 4151 South Arkansas Avenue in Russellville. And don't forget to ask about the $50 referral.
KCJC Darknell Russellville.
Hey! You guys play the best country of all.
River Country. KCJC.
Back with you on the Health Plan Lady Postgame Show from Tucker Coliseum in Russellville, where the Arkansas Tech Golden Suns have clinched their 18th consecutive postseason berth with a 67-66 win over Henderson State. Let's take a look at the numbers. Henderson State was 22 of 65 from the field tonight. That is 34%, as Coach Wilbers credited that zone defense, and Arkansas Tech really active in that zone, being able to seal off the dribble penetration while also taking away the three-point shot. And it was effective here tonight for Arkansas Tech, holding Henderson State to 7 of 21 shooting from three-point range. The Reddies were 15 out of 18, 83% at the free throw line. Arkansas Tech, 23 of 65 from the field tonight, 35%, including 8 out of 14, 57% from the field in the fourth quarter. Arkansas Tech was 4 of 11 from three-point range tonight, including 2 out of 2 in the fourth quarter. And Arkansas Tech was 17 of 23, 74% from the free throw line, including 8 out of 9 from the free throw line in the fourth quarter and 10 out of 11 from the line in the second half. Arkansas Tech out-rebounded Henderson State 50 to 41. The Reddies had 10 assists and 14 turnovers. Arkansas Tech with 8 assists and also 14 turnovers tonight. The Golden Suns had an 18-9 edge in second chance points, and the Suns outscored them 32-22 in points in the paint. Individual leaders first for Henderson State. In her final appearance at Tucker Coliseum, Ashley Farrar had 18 points tonight for Henderson State. All of them came in the second half. Olivia Allen with 13 points for the Reddies, and Brinley Huggins had 10. Other scorers for Henderson State included Jada Pickens with 7 points, Bobby Basil with 6 points, J.J. Eddins had 5 points and 6 rebounds, McKenna Winans with 4 points and 11 rebounds for the Reddies, and Sam Basson added 3 points for Henderson State. Arkansas Tech led in scoring tonight by Alex Hill with 15 points on 6 of 11 shooting from the field. Alex, at one point there midway through the fourth quarter, scored 7 straight Arkansas Tech points, and that little spurt by Hill gave the Golden Suns a lead that they did not relinquish the rest of the night. It was 11 points and 16 rebounds tonight for Julie Wagner. It was 11 points, 3 rebounds for Clara Grace Prater. Haley Wyrick had 10 points off the bench for the Golden Suns. 9 points and 11 rebounds for Dana Thompson. Shelley Butler had 6 points and 3 rebounds. Jackie Rollins had 3 points, all of them from the free throw line. And Maissa Marsall had 2 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, and 3 steals before she fouled out of the game. Final score in the women's game is Arkansas Tech 67 and Henderson State 66 from the Alathus Realty broadcast position on the Health Plan Lady postgame show. We will step aside for 4 minutes. We're 19 minutes away from the Wonder Boys. We will pause for 4 minutes, and then Kelly will bring us up to date on the GAC women's basketball scoreboard and the GAC women's basketball standing. It's all on the Health Plan Lady postgame show, back in 4 minutes. This is Arkansas Tech basketball on the EAB Sports Network.
A solid roof for your business is key to keeping your employees, products, and valuables dry and clean. If you're experiencing roof leaks that are resulting in damaged equipment, stained ceilings, and walls, then don't let Mother Nature get the best of your business. The folks at E&F Roofing offer free commercial roof inspections.